So let's get this party started. Go over to the YouTube thing. They've apparently redesigned my front page a little bit. And I'm unable to... There it is live. But it makes me do a featured thing, so I had to do that, and that was a pain in the butt. So let's pop out my chat here, get my other system set up, la-dee-dee-dee-da. Switch to live, blow it up, da-da-da-da-da. That's good enough. Go back over here and check one, check two. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Sergeant Turner, Rhode Island, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. You're a furry, not gonna lie. Okay, that's a good way, a non sequitur, to start the stream. Jeffrey, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Okay, we got this all set up, I think, here. Jason, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How you doing, man? Okay, so today, I think what we're gonna do is we're going to decorate this beast. Or try, unless everybody gets bored. Typhus, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. We're going to try and decorate this and then probably move on to starting the Kevin Alibert challenge. So we'll see how this goes. If this gets too boring, I'm just going to... You're buying a person a year. I can't take you guys anywhere, man. Okay, so while I start and do the intro here, I'm going to put up... Since this is the first video of the month, I'm going to go ahead and thank my patrons for their continued support. I am angling to get a new controller here pretty soon because this one is pretty much on its last legs and we're dying here on the vine. And but anyway, I am eternally grateful for their support and I very much appreciate it. So thank you all very, very much for your contributions to the channel here. So, Stella, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. So what I'm going to do today is slog through menus and decorate this place a little bit and fiddle with some of the stuff that I have not yet done. Because I was thinking I'd probably want to put... I probably can't put anything in this thing here. So, yeah, she's got all her junk on her. I gave the settler a Gauss rifle, so he's all set up. Dalton, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. What settlement is this, Typhus? This is Ten Pines. This is Ten Pines Bluff. We go out here, cruise out here, give you a little anchor. There's the original building. This is the bottom of the hill. And then if we go back over here, you can see the broken building in the back. And the whole settlement, my whole... Well, let me get up the friggin' ladder here. My whole settlement here is built up on the ridge that's on the front corner of it. You can see over here where the gunners are. And then the crash is over there somewhere. So yeah, it's Ten Pines. We are at Ten Pines Bluff. And this is the two-floor build challenge here for Morpheus. So what I'm going to do probably today is start this off by decorating. If it gets too boring, let me know, and we will switch to something else. But for the time being, what I want to do here I'll just wait here. We'll get some sunshine here. We'll go for 13 hours, 14 hours. We'll do that. Yeah, I don't know what that means, Sergeant. I'm sorry. I'm not hip to that particular genre. Yeah, autocorrect is pretty much a tool of Satan, isn't it, dude? But you know what? I gotta admit, it can be kind of fun. So what I want to do first, I think, is put some vault crates. Put some of those silver crates up here because he's by the wreckage, so it just makes sense that we would have okay, wait a minute. Let me sit back here. I'm hunched over again. I'm thinking the extra 8 inches that I get closer to the screen makes a damn difference, which is not. So while we do this, I have a saga for you guys today. Is it under miscellaneous? No, it's in vault, isn't it? It's in decorations. No, god damn it. It's in decorations vault. Miscellaneous. Right, okay. Yeah, these are the ones on Flight 1981. We'll do three there. And then we'll do two more here. Is that five? Is that going to be enough, do you think? If it isn't, we'll just get more later. I know I'm going to sound like an idiot. Probably show my age. What's a furry? You probably want to Google that, dude. It's people who enjoy dressing up as furry animals and cavorting. Cavorting, I think, is the best way to describe it. Cavorting is the safest way to describe it. It is an entire subculture, though. there are a lot of people who enjoy that sort of thing. I'm sure Sergeant can give you a much better explanation than I can at this point, but for our purposes, that should suffice. Let's see here. Let's do this. Yeah, okay, so same height. Yeah, a little bit lower. And then scoot her over. Yeah, that's what I want right there. Then we'll put this little sumbitch sideways on top of it. So here's why your erstwhile correspondent is an idiot and technologically incapable of most things that most people take for granted. Yesterday, so this is going to be story time, folks, while I fiddle with crates and shit. So yesterday, I noticed that JPEG had streamed State of Decay 2. And I was like, oh, I was excited. He's back in the game. Yay. It turns out he heard about the patch and wanted to check it out, whatever. So I was like, yay, he streamed it. So I'm going to watch that later. I watched part of it. Didn't have time to do it yesterday. And I don't know why it just now occurred to me, but JPEG is a PS4 player, right? He plays on PS4. But the State of Decay was released for Xbox and Windows 10, right? So he could download the PC version and play with people on Xbox in multiplayer, which he has in the past. And I was like, okay, that's cool. That's kind of neat of them to include that feature. And I don't know why it didn't occur to me, but if you buy the Xbox version of the game, you automatically get the ability to play it on PC on Windows 10 machines. You can just download it, install it, and play it. Now, one of the things about SOD2 that I was like excited for, but whatever, is that you can play multiplayer in the game, but you have to have an Xbox Live account, right? I do not have an Xbox Live account. I mean, I did at one point, thank you, Benjamin. But I don't really use it enough to justify the expense, so I don't ever do it. So I couldn't play multiplayer with my current account. And then I don't know why it took me 6 months to figure this out, folks, but it clicked. I'm like, wait a minute. I can just install it on my PC and play multiplayer that way, you know, with the thing installed on my computer rather than my laptop rather than on the Xbox. So I was like, well, shit. So, okay. Seems pretty easy. He played with Quick Smoke. Yeah, I was like, damn, man, I'm sorry I missed that. I didn't get the notification, as always, because fucking YouTube. So anywho, back to the story. So I'm like, oh, I'm all excited now. I'm like, sweet, I can play with people on Xbox. I can play SOD2 multiplayer as long as I install it to my PC. Sweet, how do I do that? So I go to Google it. And I say, how do you play SOD2 on a Windows 10 PC, and it says go install the Xbox app. Okay, I'll go install the Xbox app. That seems pretty straightforward. So I go to find the Xbox app, install it, it loads. There's no shortcut, so I can't reload it when I close it, which is exciting. And I load it up, and I fire it up, and I immediately am just assaulted by information. I just complete information saturation. I can't even make sense of what I'm seeing. There's so much shit on the screen, I'm like, what is even going on here? So I look up more Google things, and I prowl through the settings, and I dick around with this and dick around with that, and it occurs to me that so it wants me to hook it up to the Xbox. It wants me to sync it to my Xbox. Okay, sync it to my Xbox, no problem. So I fire up the little application, search for things in the network, you can't find the Xbox. Okay, cool. And then it pops up a box and says, hey, if you can't find the Xbox, put the IP of your Xbox in this field. So, another Google, how do I find the IP? Go to, you know, Systems Advanced Network Settings, blah, 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 and there's the IP. So I put the IP in the box, says, yep, can't find it. I'm like, I'm sorry, the Xbox is on, everything's on the same network, I've got it all connected, what the hell's going on here? More troubleshooting, go back to the Xbox support thing, and it's like, oh yeah, if you can't find it, it's probably not in the same sub-network, and you need to put them on the same sub-network. So I was like, okay, they're all on the same router, but then I'm like, oh, wait a minute. My laptop is wired, is hardwired, Ethernet wired, RJ45 or RJ45C or whatever the hell it is these days. I don't even know anymore. So when I stream, you know, I don't have to worry about the wireless stuff screwing up. But the Xbox is on 5G wireless. Okay, cool. No problem. I'll just turn on wireless on the laptop. So I turn on wireless on the laptop. It finds the Xbox, blah, 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 blah. Everything's copacetic. We are all happy campers. And I still can't... So I can play now on my Xbox through my computer, which is not really what I wanted to do. I wanted to play on my PC using my Xbox account. Okay. So I'm like, all right, fine, whatever. This isn't going to work. This isn't what I was after. And so I disconnect the wireless, and it goes back to wired, and I don't have any internet. Troubleshoot it. Can't figure it out. Unplug the router. Turn it off. Reboot the machine. Nothing works. It's got no internet. It's connected. It sees the wire, but it's not connected. So I troubleshoot that, and it turns out that when I turned the wireless on, I blew out the DHCP settings on my Ethernet card. So I had to get that fixed to get internet back on my computer. Okay, good. So now we're still at square one. I can't play SOD2. It's like, all right, go back to the Google. Hi, Erica. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to the saga of your technologically inept correspondent here. So then I go back and I try a different search. I'm like, okay, how you have to do it is you have to go to the Microsoft Store and download it and then log in on your Xbox Live account and do it that way. So I was like, okay, I can do that, no problem. So I get that done in the Microsoft Store, is of course going into grinding like 12 megabits a second, which is, you know, whatever. So long story long, even longer. In the process, I managed to blow out my DHCP settings, install an app I don't need, couldn't figure out what the hell was going on, and finally got SOD2 running on my PC.
Looking for trouble, I hope.
All right, cool. Got to run on the PC. It syncs to the cloud. It's logged in fine. Everything's copacetic. Okay. So I can't play on mouse and keys because, you know, the setup of my... Okay, so now we're going to go slog it to the menus, guys. We'll drop two of those. I need an aluminum canister. And, nah, don't do that. I need a screwdriver. So now I need to figure out how to hook up my controller up to my PC, because I do have the Bluetooth one, and I want to play with it. I want to try and play on the PC I can't think and do this at the same time for some reason. So I go look up, how do I do this, blah, blah, blah. It's like, oh yeah, just, you know, go to your system settings and go to Bluetooth and tell it add a device and, you know, push the button on the Xbox controller and it'll be fine. It'll work. It'll just work. Where did the wrench go? I'm like, okay, that seems simple enough, but my Bluetooth isn't activated. Apparently it's not turned on in my device manager. So I had to go Google that, figure out how to do that. I'm like, okay, we finally got that done. That's fine, whatever. And I hook it up and I get it done and it works great. But now it doesn't work on my Xbox anymore. And I'm like, why is it not working on my Xbox anymore? Well, more research, more Googling. It turns out that the Xbox controller can only be synced to one device at a time. Because I was kind of curious, right? I was like, how is this thing going to even work on an empty beer bottle? What the hell? Okay, fine. Let's go to aid beer. Drop two of these. So I figured out that every time I want to use the controller, the Xbox controller on the PC, I have to resync it, and then it blows out the syncing on the other, on the Xbox. So then after that, I have to sorry, it is really hard to tell a story and do the junk sorting at the same time. So yeah, 16 hours. It took me like 3 hours to figure all this out. Could not figure it out. Just was completely baffled by the entire thing. So we got that. We got those, right? Aluminum can. Let me, gas cans. Is it just gas can? What's it called? Is it just called gas can? I hope it is. Gas canister. There. Oh, I got 140 of them. Cool. One and two and three. Yeah, baby. I'm just going to pick these up and throw them around here. So anyway, point, long story even longer, I finally did manage to get things set up, and I do have, oh yeah, so one last thing, it gets even better. So I finally get the controller set up, I finally get everything the way I want it, I get the controller working with the PC, and I go to play. I'm like, okay, cool. I log in, and I notice that the most recent save that it has for my game is like 6 hours old on the PC. Because I have two communities running, right? One of them is correct. It was the right time. It was the right date. But the other one, I've been playing more recently, and it was not that old. Okay, that's not going to work there. So I'm like, well, shit, I can't play this. I want to play the other. I want to play that one community, but it's clearly not the current one. So then I turn it off, and I go back to my Xbox, and it syncs, and it says, hey, we have two different versions of your cloud save. There's one on your Xbox that's local is older. We have one in the cloud that is newer. Which one do you want to use? Now, it doesn't give me any details, of course. It just says this one's older, this one's newer. And I'm not kidding you guys. I sat there for 5 minutes trying to figure out which one I wanted to keep without any other information. I said, you know what? The Xbox I know is the one I was just playing last, so I'm going to keep that one. It turns out it was the correct one, so yada, yada, yada. Eva, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Cheesy, how you doing, baby? Paul, welcome to the stream, y'all. And E, welcome to the stream, y'all. Welcome to the stream. Live in Texas, not wearing fur in the summer heat. Yeah, it got nice, man. It's been nice. It's nice outside today, too. Okay, let me do this. We've got this, right? We've got his little dun thing decorated, right? We've got some gas. No, I don't like that there. Let's put it over. Let's get it away from that thing. Yeah, drop it behind the wall. So he's got some gas. He's got some oil. He's got his tools. Okay, that's decorated. We're gonna leave that alone.
Another day of hard work.
Hard work. It never changes, does it, dude? All 76 is the mass Andromeda effect. Yeah, 76 is, well, it's gonna do its thing. Whatever. You know, I wanna see if there's anything over here. I know there's these dogs over here. But is there anything I can steal to use for decoration? How often do I stream, Typhus? I stream Sundays at noon Central Time, and I stream Tuesdays at 7 p.m. Central. Tuesdays are the wild card, too. Tuesdays are not always Fallout. Tuesdays can be anything. Tuesdays might be State of Decay next time. I don't know. Where are those dogs? I know there's a little trash pile over here. You know, I'm carrying too much shit. I'm not going to try that. Let's just skip that part of the program here. Laptop died. Oh, man, that sucks, dude. Is it fixable or is it just dead? Is it just dead? My laptop sort of died yesterday, too. Mostly because I killed it. Okay. Is it dirty oven mitt? See, that's the thing I got used to, is I got used to OCD and then I have to worry about the labels, what things are called. I want an oven mitt. It's down here, right? Come on. Yeah, there it is. Oven mitt. And do I have a spatula? I got a spatula in here, don't I? Oh my god. You know what? Let's just do that. Let's drop that too. And spatula. There it is. Okay. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Let's put some stuff over here for him. Do that, and then we'll do this. Now this will not go on here, right? Right, because it's an active container. Well, like, can I put it on here? Let me. Come on, I want to put it the other way. I'm not gonna go there, is it? Nope. Okay, that's fine. We'll just leave the oven mitt up here then, I guess. And where'd my spatula go, man? I lost it in the grass. Uh-oh. Jesus, where did it go? Oh, there it is. Ta-da! Yeah, the spatula will go there just fine. You know what? No, it won't. I have to pick it up. Because it goes through the container. And we'll go like this. Yeah. There we go. Nah, I don't like that. I want to turn it. There we go. There we go, just like that. And down. Okay, so you got a spatula, plate, and thing on that. Okay. Let me catch up with the bitterly cold at the beginning of the week here. Not super warm. Yeah, it's same out here. It's up and down, up and down. Isn't Bethesda getting sued for misrepresentation? Dalton asked. No, they're getting sued for that for the special edition. Pretty much doesn't recognize the hard drive. Well, that sucks, man. I hope you can get it fixed, man. Oh, you can replace it. Excellent. Okay, E. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Hoard certain type of junk. Yeah, Eva, I'm a pack rat, too. I'm a pack rat. Why does that spatula look like a knife? I don't know. It's weird, isn't it? It's kind of strange. Very flat blade of metal. But it's a spatula. It's more like a turning spatula than a spatula spatula. But it's close enough for our purposes. Do I need to decorate out here? Nah, it's hay bales. We don't need anything out there. Yeah, okay. What I need now, too, is... yeah, see, the grass makes it hard to see. But we're going to try here. Back to the junk. Back to the junk. I got a shovel here, right? Got a shovel. And I need a hoe. I need a hoe! Not that kind of hoe. Do I even have a hoe? Horton, here's a hoe. Dun, 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 dun. They're being sued for the special edition because apparently it came with like a nylon bag. It was advertised having a nylon bag. Or canvas bag, I'm sorry, canvas bag. And it shipped with what basically amounts to a trash bag. People are understandably unhappy about this because the bag as advertised was pretty sweet and, you know, getting your stuff tucked into a hefty bag is not quite as cool. But they offered like 500 atomic
run by ghouls?
Atomic points or something like that. And I'm like, yeah, I guess that's okay. But people are very dissatisfied because it's actually misrepresentation, you know. I mean, even though they did say, you know, may not be exactly as it appears and blah, 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 blah. Their handling of the issue was somewhat less than satisfactory to a lot of people because they outsourced it, apparently, or something. Again, secondhand information, as I understand it, yada, yada, yada. But yeah, people are very unhappy about it. Which, you know, can't blame them. I mean, they paid for one thing and got something completely, completely different. Same in kind, but not in, reality. Yeah, that's good. Shovel and a hoe. Okay. Stop calling me hoe. $500 is an insult. It could have been, yeah, considering how much the special edition cost, it should have been closer to maybe 2,000. But even then, I mean, if I'm paying cash money, I don't want fake money in return. But then again, I didn't pay for it anyway. So my opinion is NA, invalid in this context. It does not matter what I think because I am not the intended audience and I am not the aggrieved party, shall we say. Okay, well, we're going to hand decorate this shit. Do I have anything in aid that is... Yeah, you know what? We'll drop one of these. Put an ant meat on the grill here. Going to barbecue up some ant meat because he's fancy that way. Why not? And put that there. Yeah, that's fine. And then we'll put... I need junk. Damn it, I keep hitting the trigger instead of the stick for this. Can. Give me can. Is it empty can? Damn it. I can never remember the name of these damn things. Empty can? Ah! Only one? Oh, it's not that. Is it just can? Tin can. It's tin can. This definitely explains about OCD. Well, okay. So, Eva, on that score, you were correct. It can be irritating in that the settler will knock things off, but since I have been decorating in vanilla for so long, and there's only one settler here, I can plan it because I know how they path, right? I know how they walk and I know how they interact with objects. So when you look at this, you will find that anywhere that is heavily decorated is somewhere the settler will never go.
Got a dangerous look about you.
Because I know how they path and I know what they interact with. So in this particular instance, the only danger I have is stuff falling off shelves when it loads. But the settler will not knock things off. He'll never go in here, right? He'll farm his mute fruit, but the closest he'll get is right here. Same thing with Same thing with these. He'll use the cooking station, but there's no way he'll ever path towards it from this direction. He always goes wide around it and then comes right at it. So he won't knock those things off. And when it comes to the chairs up here, he'll come up the stairs and he'll go directly to the chair. So he won't touch anything on here. He won't touch anything here. He won't interact with either of these objects. Now, of course, if an explosion hits the damn thing, of course, I mean, you know, what are you going to do there? But yeah, I always, when I place objects for settlers to interact with, I always keep their pathing in mind. So when I do go place things, it'll be much less likely that they will run into stuff. I mean, they still can, but I don't think they will. But that's just because I've had this mentality for a long time. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, let's grab the spatula and put it up here. Anything can happen, but I'm fairly confident that this stuff will largely stay put. Yeah, spatula there. We'll put some tin cans down over here on the bottom. Dun, 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 dun. Put one there. Also, there aren't a lot of stacked objects here, so the stuff probably will not fall to the shelves. And if it does, it will not be very much. So, I mean, I ain't no Phoenix, man, but I do okay. I do all right. I do all right. Okay, now I want that one pushed a little bit further in. Put his tin cans down there, and then we'll get a can of, what is it? Pork and beans. Pork and beans. Where's my pork and beans? Pork and beans. 70. I'll get 2 of them out. What the hell? Why not? Okay. Put one up here. Oh, come on, man. Rotate it. So let me see what the message you're trying. Someone looking good. Love the reload. Thank you, Galaxy Punk, and welcome to the stream. Me and that damn Mr. Handyfield. Dude, it's my signature, dude. That and, so yeah. And my Wii noises when I play, my drinking game Wii noises that Doc Type loves so much when I play Skyrim. You gotta stick with what you know, man. You gotta stick with what you know. And Doc Type, welcome to the stream, man. How you doing? Speak of the devil? Oh my goodness gracious. Cram. Gonna heat up his cram on the grill. In fact, let's just put it on top of the spatula if I can. How's my depth perception today? Is it good? Hey, not bad. Not bad. So yeah, he's gonna be heating up some pork and beans and cram on the grill there. Okay, so now we need plates. Okay, let me see what we got here. Not immersive gameplay. Yeah, no kidding. And Fergie, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Free space and anything in immersive. Ruben, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Playing New Vegas. Yeah, New Vegas, it grabs you, doesn't it? I mean, it's just astonishing how deep it is. Let's give him a TV dinner tray. What the hell? I'm not going to mess with this. It's here. It's close. It's good enough. It is good enough. Give him a TV dinner tray. And then we'll put some vodka out here. Since I'm down here in the T's and the V's. I gotta be an aide. D. Dun, 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 dun. We'll give him whiskey instead. Whiskey's better. It's better for you. Good, and it's good for you. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna go into build mode for this one. And then we'll put a plate out there. I guess I'll put a silver plate. No. No, I need, we'll put a ribeye steak on his plate. Why not? He's got a Brahmin. It makes sense, right? Sure. And then what else do I need on here? Glass. I need a drinking glass. Need to go into junk for that one. So, la-di-di-di-da. Drinking glass. Yay for scrolling. JPEG's going to be pissed off that he missed this. Scrolling through menus, baby. Scrolling through the menus. Drinking glass, drinking glass. Okay, up you go. So, okay, drinking glass. And we need something for that, but what would he put there? Oh, no, don't do that. Dun, 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 dun. Put a tato on the plate. Okay. I'm pretty sure I got one. Tato! Yeah, I got 332 of them, dude. Here we go. Oh, don't go rolling off. No. Don't go rolling off. No. No, don't go rolling off. Okay. Tato on the Play-Doh. Tato on the Play-Doh. You know he needs a fork, too. Silver. Give me a silver. Oh, well, dinner fork's here. We'll use that one. We're closer. That's the one we're going to use. No. What happens if I go into build mode when I'm holding something? Oh, it keeps it holding. Perfect. Oh, shite. That's fine. Whatever. Oh, I can hold. That's weird. Okay. I can't let it go. Okay, so there's your lesson for the day, folks. You can, if you hold it when you're going into build mode, it'll continue to hold it and you'll never be able to drop it. That is weird. I've never tried that before. That was dumb. All right, put that there. And then, what have we got? Yeah, we'll put a dirty ashtray out there. That seems sufficient. That seems appropriate. Friggin' animals. Indeed. And then, down we go. Down to pee. Need to go to pee. Need to pee. Pack of cigarettes. Only 206? Okay, that's fine. Whatever. Okay, there we go. Pack of cigarettes will do. Pop. Okay, so there's his table. There's his dining area. He's got a cooking station, but he's got a grill up here, too. I don't know. But that's okay. So let's go ahead and quick save. Roger Rabbit, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Attachment issues. Yeah, no kidding, right, Doc? With that fork. I've never actually tried to go into build mode while I was holding something before. That's interesting that you cannot drop it. Very, very peculiar. Okay, so what have we got here? Let's go for the pack of cigarettes. And then dirty ash. Oh, wait a minute. New cola bottle. Sure, I'm here. Drop that. New cola bottle. And... yeah, what the hell? We'll put a hot plate on there. Something a little bit different. And... what was I doing? What have I got going here? Got a pack of cigarettes. Dirty ashtray. Dirty ashtray. And then an empty vase. Empty floral barrel vase. Sure. Okay, so there's going to be my... there's going to be my thing. Roger! Roger, it is going very well today. Thank you. The sun is shining. The weather is mild. And we're decorating, which is, well, not thrilling. I got my vitamin D therapy yesterday, which I haven't had in a while, and it was very nice. Very pleased with what in the hell is this bottle even doing. Dude, what in the hell are you doing? Okay, no, we're gonna have to pick you up manually, man, because that's weird. And it's good. Getting out and doing the thing was very pleasant. I haven't done it in a while. I forgot how nice it is. So, you know what? Fuck it, I'm just going to place these manually. It's just easier. That's not close enough. You know, this is dumb. I got an ashtray and an ashtray, so let's not put that ashtray out there. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. We'll drop a coffee cup out there, too, because I like coffee cups. Give me that coffee cup. Where's my coffee cup? Coffee cup. 301. Oh, that's the nacho commemorative coffee cup. I got 300 of them. Yeah, this one's fine. That one will work. I'm gonna need a coffee pot then, aren't I? Coffee pot. Well, if you want to go on a Dune tangent, feel free. You have people that would be happy if you did. I'm looking at you, Groucho. And depth perception, ahoy. Okay, that's too far. Right there. Hey! Okay, so that'll be good. I don't think they'll knock anything off that table. And quick save again. How bad is it to use Great Mentats in survival mode? I don't really use chems in survival because I don't like the penalties. It's just, you know, it makes you hungry, thirsty, sleepy, whatever. But it's no worse than any other chem. They're not particularly bad, if that makes any sense. Okay, so what have we got? What have we got else to decorate here? Let me do another recap. We're gonna walk back out here. So he's got his tools there. We've got his stuff in here.
Crop's been growing pretty good lately.
I'm glad the crop's been growing pretty good lately, dude. You just keep up the good work, son. So he's got that. We've got this. That's all done. The field is done. Lower field is done. This has some stuff on it. That's fine. The top is done. Right? Yes. That looks pretty good. The cow doesn't need any decoration. And then this has some stuff on the table here. Some random crap. Okay, that's fine. We don't need any decoration here, so I guess all that's left is his house. This went pretty quick, guys. I didn't think it was going to take a lot longer than this. Okay. He doesn't have a shelf, so there's no storage there. So all I got to do to decorate is this table. Well, let's go out here. Let's put down... let's do this. Let's do his, oh, I miss OCD right now. Just the interminable scrolling. Okay, come here, you. Now, this is the challenge when I'm decorating in tight spaces. Because if you get too close to it, if your cursor goes in the lip, it does funky things to the thing. So there's that. Give me this. Back out. Okay. Good, good. Everybody's cool, right? Yeah, good. Okay. And then we'll add silt bean. Give me a silt bean. Even though it's not used for chems, it is a good size. So we're going to turn this bad boy around. We're going to stick it underneath here. Come on. Come on, go in there. And right. Okay, so there's that. Now, are these under glass? They're under glass, right? All the beakers and shit, they're under glass. Oh, well, they're in junk. They're not in aid, so maybe you go there first, dumb shit. Ah! Glass, 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 glass. Okay, glass pitcher. Glass barrel. Is it just beaker? Glass pitcher, glass rounded vase, vaulted vase. Yeah, they're not in glass at all. Is it beaker? No, what's the... Damn it, I forgot what it's called. The round... Son of a bitch, I forgot what it's called. Chemistry... Is it under chemistry? Chemistry jar. There it is! Yay! One, two, and three. Yeah, oh, look at that. And they all sat up. Perfect. Come here, you. Give him some chemistry jars on the chem station. And, of course, if you place these far back, he will not knock them over. He only hits things on the front half of it that I've seen. So, that will be sufficient for our purposes here. We'll just put some chemistry jars here for him on the... on the thing there, yeah. Now, I don't stack things because if I stack them, they'll fall over for sure. But we don't want it too tidy because he's kind of a slob. So let's put it on its side. Stick it there. Okay, so chemistry jars there. And then, well, I'll just put some chems here, right? Day tripper, one. And then jet. Always got to have jet. Jet, 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 jet. Two jets, one, two, a mentats, and a psycho. Funny, I pick up all these drugs, but I never use them. I squatted. Damn it. That's fine. I'm just going to get him up here and then I'll move him around. Mentats. Right. Jet. Psycho. And jet. Okay. How is that? Yeah. Stand up. Yeah, that's not terrible. Let's move it right there. Mentats, jet, some stuff right there, some chemistry stuff there. It's okay, he's good there. Says now they'll end up in the field. Yeah, who knows, man? That's the thing, when you're decorating vanilla, man, you have to just cross your fingers and hope for the best. Okay, so here we're gonna put miscellaneous sort by weight, because that's what I want right there. Gonna give him an overdue book. And we're gonna give him more whiskey. Yay. Gonna do whiskey. And then we're gonna do of course. Cigarette cart, sure. And teal. I need teal. Oh, wait. Oh no, those are the fancy ones. Need teal. Where's my teal? Come on. Yay, this is exciting. Teal barrel vase, teal bud vase. Okay. I brought my steak on the table. I got a ribeye up there on the grill up top, so he's good there. We're good. A little vase. And then a carton of cigarettes. Yeah, carton of cigarettes. Bottle of whiskey. Shot glass and an ashtray. Dun, 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 dun. Only 45 shot glasses. A. And up to the D's. The exciting theme music. You can read in the dark. Oh, no, don't do that. Okay. Dirty ashtray. And a shot glass. Doc's obviously going to read in the dark. Well, I'm hoping this light will give him some light. So, yeah, hopefully that'll do the trick, man. I mean, you know, if it doesn't, well, he's on his own. Lit cigarette. Last thing. Lit cigarette. Now to place this bad boy. He'll read by starlight. Well, he's got a lantern right outside, too, so if he wanted to, he could bring that in. He could do that. But, yeah, this is not going to work because it goes through the ashtray. That's fine, though. Now we're going to eyeball this bad boy. How close do we get? Not close at all. Okay. Move a little bit closer. Oh, I can't do it. Can I get the drop? Nope. Okay. Oh, the things we do for decorating. Son of a... See, that's what nice about OCD, man. It behaves. It puts things on the top of the ashtray like it should. I guess the glow... Is that right? No. Oh, God, I am just... You can't take me anywhere, man. Okay, you know what? Let's back up a little bit. Let's do that. A cigarette, right? Okay. Move forward a little bit. Move down a little bit. And... Yeah, that's close enough. Fuck it, I ain't doing that no more. Sushi, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Long time no see. How you doing? You gotta go, Typhus? Alright, man. Thanks for stopping by the stream. Good to see ya. You can't imagine building without mods. It's honestly, I built without mods for so long because I didn't, when I first started the channel, right, I didn't want to have anything on here that PlayStation people couldn't do. So I built vanilla for a really long time, you know. And then when they got mods, I started using mods. But they have their advantages and disadvantages, you know. I mean, on the one hand, I do have a lot of cool shit, and that's fine. But on the other hand, you don't get this. Pop! The build menu just comes right the hell up. Fink! So, don't eat me. Wait, what? Oh, God. Okay, that's not going to go anywhere good, so I'm just not going to leave that one alone. So we're going to quick save again. And now this thing is ready for the tour. So next week, what I might do is just do a tour so Morpheus can link to it on his channel. But yeah, we're decorated. That's all there is to it. Took what? 45 minutes? Yeah, Jesus. 45 minutes to do this shit. So, let's go ahead and sleep here really fast. Yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and sleep for 13. It's 9, 10, 11, 12. We'll go for noon. And I'm going to put my thing up here and thank my patrons again for their continued and appreciated support. It means the world to me, and it helps out so much. So, thank you all to these fine people for their additional support of the channel. And we're going to take this off, and boop, ta-da! Truflot, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. I liked your video on the stairs, man. I never thought about snapping the stairs to a sinkable object like that. I'll be stealing that and using that in some future build, that's for sure. So, okay, we are at noon here today. And by the way, folks, click those three dots next to Truflot's name in the chat window and go check out his channel. If you click go to channel, it will pop a new tab or new window for you so you can check it out later. But he's got some quality stuff up there already. For a first-time new YouTuber, man, he sure hit the ground running. So, here is our finished settlement. This whole thing is only two floors. We'll do a little quick run through here, and then we'll get on to the business of going down to Merc, going down and building our Kevin thing, and in a different place. So, the entrance, as such, is here. Looks like this from the bottom. Pretty good. Pretty good. Yeah, the chem station, the round chem station and the round thing really do a good job there. So you go in here. It's kind of a crappy gate. Kind of a interesting entrance here. The turret, of course, looking right through the gap. Spikes to keep it from going up there. And then the vendors can come hang out over here. Can come visit, get a cup of coffee or Nuka-Cola or whatever, have a smoke, and then they can go in the poop room back here. Yeah. We're going to do this really quick so I don't waste a lot of time doing this. The main entrance to his little hut thing is here. Looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. Not terrible. Then up the ramp we've got our cow, Moo, with his outdoor cooking station. And then he does his work back here in the field. Down the ramp over the thing where the fertile soil is. His
if you work, you eat.
Power station is here. Not too shabby. Got his necessaries. Excuse me, sir. And we go up the ramp here. His main house is here. Got his roof top promenade seat here. Yeah, this came out pretty good. That's pretty good decoration. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Then we go in here into his main living area. Got his radio and his light with the wire going out the window. So nice. Just a little relaxation spot there. And then his chems, where he does his stuff. Right here on the deck, where he can see the gunners. Yay, hooray. So, okay, well, I guess we can put this one to bed. Yeah, that was not bad. That was a fun little challenge. I'll have to do do a completed video tour next week if I can find the friggin' time. And we'll post that as a separate video. Kevin says hi. He sat beside me. Oh, hi, Kevin. How you doing? You are tuning in at a good time. I'm about to start on your build because I was going to do it here, right? I was going to turn this into the story 8-floor, you know, story 8-floor thing. It's going to come the new year. Well, that's cool, Sushi. I mean, if you can, great. If you can't, that's fine, too. I mean, God knows with Kevin moving in, y'all have got expenses, so I am a low priority on that one. But thank you very much. Got a double thumbs up. But yeah, the original plan was to take this, build two floors, and then grow this thing to make Kevin's, right? But looking at it, I mean, I'd have to tear down half of it just to make have it make sense, because it sort of is its own thing, you know? I mean, if I added six floors, I mean, I'd put them over here, and it would just make it just wouldn't feel right. It would look unbalanced. So we're going to leave this here. And for Kevin's challenge, I'm still going to be in vanilla, not going to be using the mods, but where am I going to build? I ate floors, got to tell a story. Where is it going to be? Well, you know what? One of the hardest places to build in vanilla is Murkwater. Absolutely. Devil Dog, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, and thanks. Yeah, it's just a tiny little one-person chem maker farm. That's all it is. Eva. All right, Eva. Thank you for stopping by the stream. I hope you're feeling better soon. Hope the stuff works. I mean, obviously it does if you're getting more. Duh. So I was going to build Somerville, but I've built there before, and it's got people, and I don't want people there. Egret Tours, I still am leery about that one. Still leery about that one. Warwick's got people. Spectacle's too big. The castle? The castle just says Minutemen. Coastal Cottage. Kevin says, no, that's Coastal Cottage. Hardest places to build. Kevin, I'm going to disagree with you a little bit on that one. Coastal Cottage is the hardest if you want to do anything with the house. Okay? But if you ignore that broken house completely, Coastal Cottage is really quite nice. Okay? It's just overgrown and kind of a piece of shit if you can't scrap all the bushes. There's too many bushes. Sunshine? Yeah, maybe. It doesn't really fit with the story I think I want to tell here. Dockside says Egret outside your comfort zone. The thing about Egret, though, Doc, is that everything is already there. You know what? Hell with it. Let's just go there. Let's go there and Kevin fixes the houses. See? Yeah, if that's true. You know what, though? I don't know. Maybe it's a tie between that and Croup Manor. Croup Manor is a pain in the ass for fixing that house, man. It's just because all that shit on the ground floor, it does not play nice. Now, see, Egret Tours. Okay, so I'm taking Doc's suggestion. We're going to look at Egret Tours here. If I were going to tell a story, I mean, I'm kind of limited here, right? Without mods, I can't scrap all this trash. So I'm stuck with all this shit here, right? And Egret Tours is another challenging one to fix. But then again, Egret Tours is pretty nice once you get the... Once you get that floor snapped in above this little ramp thing, it's a lot easier because stuff does snap pretty good once you get above that level. But Egret is just... I mean, I've already built on that hill once, and that's my instinct, you know, build on the hill. You got the boathouse, which I could do, but you're going to be doing yours in Murkwater. See, Sushi, great minds think alike. My first thing was to go to Murkwater. Because it's interesting, you know, because it's easy, but it's hard. And this thing here, right, this building here, can't do shit with this. I mean, if you could sink things into the floor here and then sort of try and conduit your way around it. But even then, I mean, it's a finished building. It is what it is, right? The boathouse is good with mods because it's a nice, even structure. And there's some stuff in the box here. Did I get this chest? Yeah, I got the steamer trunk. Oh, I'll take the pillows while I'm here. What? I'm overloaded anyway, so I might as well, right? But, yeah, I don't know. Egret Tours... Plus, Egret Tours is big, you know? It's just... It's too large for my... It's just too big for me. But it does have wooden boxes, so hooray, hurrah. I like these wooden boxes. I love the little cardboard boxes, wooden boxes, storage crates... containers and shit. So yeah, I don't know, Doc. This is a... What story do you tell? Oh, look, it's a shipping place. Well, yeah, great. I mean, that's what it is. So it's a shipping place and a tourist trap and a mini mall. And, I mean, I guess I could build up on the roof, right? Because I've done that, or I've done that before, or I've seen that done before. I think I've seen that done before. I don't think I've ever actually built up on the roof. But you can do, let's see. You know, I gotta tell you guys, this is something I wish I could do in real life. If I want to get up on somewhere, bring it. Just build a couple ladders really quick and climb up there and see what's up there. But you can't do that in real life, so. Yeah. Oh, the Fallout building thing. Can I snap it here now? Yeah. But if you go up here, right, there's this huge deck up here where you can build all kinds of shit. But it's, again, it's kind of limited. Because there's a lot of obstructions and stuff, you know? And it's not very friendly to that sort of thing. Anything in the trash can? Nope. Okay. So let me do here. So little space at croup, yeah, but you just have to fix it. Yeah, I mean, I saw one person, at one point I saw somebody that built like a market around that center fountain thing. So that turned out pretty good. Like when they build markets around the tree and sanctuary in the roundabout. You do have to answer to Jesus. I have not worried about that dock in probably 3 decades. And that's for a good reason. A lot of good reasons, my friend. A lot of good reasons. Egret Tours. I don't like tackling this without mods. Because it has so much trash. You know? Because it has so much trash. And Coastal Cottage. Have I even done anything with Coastal Cottage? It's 0 and 50. All right, Bergie, we will see you briefly soon as you return. Okay, Coastal Cottage. Yeah, I haven't done shit with this. I haven't done anything with this. Look at this. The boxes are still here. The trashy boats are still here. Again, this is another one I don't like to tackle without mods because I hate this truck. And I've always been curious, man, can you imagine driving a semi up this road? I mean, seriously? Take a big old flatbed up here, right? And then kind of drive it into the pit, or the pit open up underneath it, I guess, and in 200 years there'll be a sinkhole. But what is the story on this truck, man? And it's, you can see how it's kind of buried halfway in the house, so it crashed through the house at some point. What? Can you link Kevin's video? Yeah, sushi, absolutely. Sushi, link it. It's linked in the description. At least it should be. I got Morpheus and Kevin's linked in there, along with a little summary of the rules. But yes, absolutely link it in here. Link it, link it, link it. You can, if you don't understand French, you can CC, you can close caption it and translate it. And it's a pretty good translation. It's pretty understandable. So, the rules, doctor in the description. It's basically 8 floors, tell a story, don't use decorating mods. That's pretty much it. That's the sum of it. And of course the video came more than 5 minutes because Kevin doesn't want to watch 6,000 videos that are 20 minutes apiece because that'd be insane. Which is completely understandable. Yeah, Coastal Cottage. I've always wanted to, well, I have done something with this house, huh? In the mega build, I did something with that. Okay, so Coastal Cottage is right out. Right out. Kingsport. Yeah, see, Kingsport's another one of those ones. It's just, the English video for the challenge. Okay. And back. Fergie, welcome back. Hopefully you can stay. Hopefully your internet lets you stay. Rubber duck got caught. What's your 20? I'm in a sinkhole, goddammit. What? What's going on over here? I hear gamma guns farting. The blurpy noise. Gunner? Raider? Gunner captain? Oh, it's a plasma rifle going off. Look at this Raider, man. He's giving him the what for. Check him out, man. Are you going to kill him? Look at him, he's not even shooting the Raider, dude. Oh, now he's finally shooting him, Jesus. But dude, a machete against a plasma rifle? Dun 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 dun. Come on, play the theme music here. What is he even doing? Oh, spin! Man, who's gonna win this? Are they even gonna kill each other? Uh oh, he booted him. I don't know why this is so damn entertaining, but it is. I hope you guys find it entertaining. I want to see who wins. That Raider's got a ton of health, man. They both do, really. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Losing the signal. They're behind the bushes. Oh, the Raider lost. Okay. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Collect your bets. Whoever bet on the gunner sergeant, win their bets. Quentin Tarantino should write that. Not enough feet, Doc. Not enough feet. Oh my goodness gracious. Oh my goodness. Echo Lake Lumber Mill. Skit, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. I don't like Far Harbor. I don't like Far Harbor at all. And Echo Lake is one of those ones, again, it's like Eager Tours, right? It's really big, but it's really complicated. And without mods, it'd be really hard to do. At least for what I'm thinking. So let's go ahead and go to... let's go to Zemonja first. We gotta go to Zemonja first, right? Where is Zemonja? Over here. Da 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 da. Do 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 do. Because I need to move someone to Vault 88, so I can throw a provisioner line out to You guys are at 71. What? Ah! Oh my god, personal space! You had your... Had a horn up my pooper, dude. What's up with that shite?
Easy living, this ain't.
No, I don't like your voice. You, however... Is there... Okay, is there a spot under there where they stand? Because she looks like she's in a guard pose, man. Okay, who else we got here? Although I like her. I like the surveyor outfit with the newsboy cap. That's a good look. So maybe I'll grab... Who are you?
Out here, you gotta take things one day at a time.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you know what? You're going. You're the one going. Let's move you to Vault 88. And I'll be able to find you very easily. Three people. Okay. Well, it's 71 and going up, so that's fine. Oh, I totally missed you. Nah. Nah, I picked the right one. So now let's go to Vault 88. Build a bell and ring it. Dun, 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 dun. You cook some dinner? Okay, so Kevin's gonna be talking now. Cool. Hi, Kevin. Dun, 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 dun. Drink. Oh no, the drinking game's only for Tuesday nights, dude. Only for Tuesday nights. Sunday afternoon hardcore drinking is a little bit.
Yes.
No. Okay, do I have beds here? No, I do not. See, I knew I didn't have enough beds here. So let's remedy that. One and two and three. Okay. Now where is? Okay, Valerie's going to sleep. She's going back in her thing.
Yeah.
I don't see the new settler yet. Probably got to make a bell and ring it. Where is my last settler? I need my settler. And it's in resources, right? Miscellaneous? Is that where the bell is? Tells you how much I use it. Oh, there we are. Yeah, here we go. Futuristic Vault 88 and a friggin' bell on a wooden post. Sure. Because that is high tech. Ring. Ding. And ding. Come on, boys. Everybody gather up. See if I can find that other damn settler. She's even here yet. I'm gonna have to wait. Where are you at? You, and you.
If you're just going to spin your legs for an hour, the power cycle is pretty fun.
Thanks, Clem. You're so excitable and enthusiastic about everything. I wonder what you're on other than stupidity. Rah.
Finally, Vault 88's work can truly begin.
Okay, so that settler is definitely not here yet. Okay, let's go ahead and wait for an hour in my super chair. La-de-dee. Hi, Kevin. Hi, man. How you doing? 13 arrows. One kill. Oh, dude. Come on. I was doing pretty good once I got used to it. Just don't even do that, man. Why you gotta do me like that, dude? Let's just wait for 8. What the hell? And I guess while that's going, I'll just put this up again and thank my patrons for their continued support. I really do appreciate all their contributions to the channel. And we will be helped defend Abernathy. That also is not going to happen.
Finally, okay. Vault 88's work can truly begin.
La-dee-dee. Whenever it starts, says we, take a drink. Wee! The baker's dozen bow. Clem's great. You need an empty vault for a very special project. Can't talk about the cat around. Okay, that's fair enough. Secrecy is fine, dude, as long as it's for a good cause rather than a bad one. That settler is not here yet. I need to get that settler here before I can do this, though. Dun, 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 dun. Let's wait another 24 hours. Yada yada yada. This is some compelling, compelling television. Dun, 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 dun. Have I ever built a vault? No. Dalton, the closest I ever got was using the vault pieces for the mega build at Starlight. I kept dinking around with it, kept fiddling with it, but it never felt right, you know? I'm a scrappy builder. I like scrappy stuff. I like stuff that blends in vaults. Vaults don't blend. Oh, there she is. Yay. Failed help defend Abernathy Farm. I don't give a crap.
Is this damn thing rigged?
Yes, it is rigged! It is rigged. It is absolutely rigged. You're going to Murkwater, right? Send Settler to... Assign supply line, yes. Okay, so the supply line is set for Murkwater. And let's check the map, make sure it is there. Is Vault 88 my main hub? No. I generally use it as my main hub in the south because it's easy to throw off supply lines to here. Somerville, Eager Tours, Jamaica Plain, Warwick, and Spectacle. And the lines don't cross. You know, it's just a good natural... Jamaica Plain used to be it because it's, you know, centrally located among all those different ones. But I like Vault 88 better because I can keep my settlers inside. It's a lot harder to build a vault. Yeah, it's just, it's for a very good cause, not before a year. Yeah, it sounds like a major project you've got going there, Kevin. Vault is not my style. Yeah, it's just not, I mean, I've tried it, and the pieces are all fiddly, and it's just a pain in the ass, and I'm like, you know, I've seen some really cool vaults, don't get me wrong, but it's not my cup of tea. Cup of tea. It's not my cup of tea. Hey, Provisioner. How you doing, dude? What's in the bench here? Yeah, what the hell, I'll take it off. And I'm already weighing 18,000 pounds, so. But yeah, vaults just don't really do it for me, you know? They're just not, Okay, so Murkwater Construction Site. We are up in the thing. And this is my favorite cover. I love this cover. It's so 50s. So 50s. And... here we are at Murkwater Construction Site. Let's go ahead. All right, Paul. We'll see you later, man. Thanks for stopping by the stream. Good to see you as always. And let's put all the ammo in there. 10 millimeter, we'll put 1021. Yeah, 1021. Let's lighten ourselves up a little bit so it gets out of my... And 2170, yeah, that'll be fine. Oh, 143 fusion cores, yeah, that's a little excessive. Sure, why not? And pipe pistol, put the road leathers in there. And put all this crap in there. Yay, more menu menagling, more menu fiddling. Blue skies of Murkwater. Yes, I have. That is why I have the weather thing. Now, when I do the tour of this place, I'll probably turn the weather mod off because, you know, the weather adds so much to the ambiance of this place. But for building and watching it on the stream, it sucks to sit here in the rain and have it all dark and grim and boring and shitty. So, but yes, Whenever I build, I like to have the, I don't need purified water with this person. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Stick all this crap in here. Oh, I don't need to worry about that. They're weightless. Yeah, this is easy mode. Well, non-survival mode, not easy mode, just non-survival. 2, 3, 4, and there. Okay, 72 out of 480. And let's put all those things in there. I'm so stupid. What am I even doing, dude? I'm just going to keep all my ammunition on me because it doesn't matter. It doesn't weigh anything. It doesn't weigh anything. Herp-a-der. I always forget that. Okay. Oh, look, I just got some experience for somebody killing something off the screen. Yay! Ka-ching! Ka-ting, ka-ting, ka-ting! Why with the weird names for armors? Weird names. You mean here? Kevin, is this what you're talking about? This tells me, this is how I know what I've got. So when I look at my armor, I know what my legendaries are. Arm left has strength and endurance. Arm right has agility perception. The chest has agility perception. The head, of course, is armored. The left leg has agility perception. The right leg has 10% movement speed. It's just my notepad, basically. That's all they are. It tells me the location and the legendary. So that's why I do it that. So when I'm playing a new game, right? If I don't have this connotation, if I don't have this type of name, I know I need to improve it. But these, I know they're all done. So, and then when I get a new legendary, I can quickly look at my armor and say, do I want to improve this or what? So, I guess we're going to do, since we don't have anybody here, is we are at an hour and 12. So I'm going to go ahead before we start the breakdown here and take a quick stretch break and bio and refill my water and all that other snazzy crap. So we're going to leave right here, take a little 3 to 5 minute intermission, smoke them if you got them, and I will be right back. All right. Let's see what we got here. Turn that thing off. Scroll back to chat. See what I missed. If I missed anything that anybody asked. What I call his guns impractical. Place anywhere. Da, da, da. Oh, using mods is fine, man. Mods is fine. Place anywhere. Yeah, place anywhere is crazy, man. I mean, it can be a little fiddly, but once you get used to it, it's super, super simple. There's a lot of tutorials on YouTube about it, so you can get that done. And yeah, when it comes to the armor, I'm practical. The guns, yeah, as noted, I do have... What did I name my guns this time? Nothing. Yeah, because she's just a throwaway. I really didn't bother with that. Because she was just for the one contest thing. I didn't really plan on playing her again. But, well, we're going to do it, so why the hell not? It's the PC version, so it's different? Okay. Yeah, the PC thing, man. PC is, like, powerful as hell, but also, if you're used to a controller, it can be incredibly complicated. So if you've been watching these streams, you watched it before, you know this part of the phase is looking. This is the thinking part of our program. This is where I try and figure out what the hell I'm going to even do. So to do that, what do I need? I need stairs. Let's get some stairs here and examine what we've got to work with. So I've only built at Murkwater like twice, you know? At least seriously. And what have we got here? Okay. So we've got the entrance ramp down there. Yeah. And we've got... the corner down there is pretty fertile. We could use that for farms if I was going to go that way, but I'm not. And of course, this monster right in the middle that I can't scrap any... I can't scrap any of that shit on the outside of it. Murkwater cannibals. Yeah, I remember. I saw that one, I think. I'm pretty sure I saw that one. That was the one that had that nice elevated walkway, covered walkway in the middle of the water, right? Something's going on nearby. Is it Toy Factory? No, it's the checkpoint over there. It's the checkpoint over there by the vertebrate. Brotherhood of Steel's fighting gunners or super mutants. Yeah, super mutants. They always fight a lot over there by the thing. But yeah, that checkpoint gets... Yeah, see some stray laser fire or whatever. I don't care. Okay, so let's get back to the business at hand here. Yeah, and in fact, I've got to defend the checkpoint on there. So, no, I want concrete floors. I want to use steel for these. I don't want to use... Let's do that. Oh, come on. Steel. Okay. Build myself a platform and look around here. Oh, I need to be in build mode so I can see the borders. Okay, so we've got that little slope on the hill. We got this little, like, swamp part that kind of curves around there. And there's that little spot there in the back of the trees where I built that one elevated shack that one time. Am I going to use that broken building? I don't think I'm going to. I think I'm going to use this. And build it out on the water. If I can. Their corpses. Hey man, just another day in the Commonwealth, am I right? Just another day in the Commonwealth. So with this thing, which is a fairly small build area... And we got this part down here, where that truck is. Let's see what we got here. Just go ahead and pick this up. Run the hell over here. Do that so I can see the damn thing. Put it over here in the other corner. Get another viewpoint. Okay. Thank goodness I cleared this a long time ago, so the Murkwater Queen, Myrler Queen, is not here anymore. So down there... it has some potential. Someone attacking you. No, Jason, that's the checkpoint. Over there by the bird. Brotherhood of Steel is fighting some super mutants right now. When they kill them, I get experience points. Okay. So, build out on the water? Build down into the corner? Build in the back there, scrap those trees. See, I wish this building was somewhere else, because this spot right here would be perfect to... Well, of course it's perfect to build on. They built a house there. Maybe back in that corner? Can I build back in that corner? I mean, I've done that before. A lot of bushes back here, though. But we do have some natural trees here. Let's get in there to look at this bad boy from a different angle. As I continue to evaluate, well, we're going to try and start. Because once I start, I don't want to, you know... Is this hitting something? Yeah, it's probably hitting the tree. Okay, let's drop that there. Let's see what we got up here. Yeah, it was hitting the tree. So if we look at it from this direction... This is a pretty small build area, huh? Actually, this is about the size of a camp in 76, ain't it? Roughly speaking. Well, if I use that... I could use that as a store, as a front, and then push it all back into the trees. But I really want to use that building for the workshop, and if I join the two together... If I join the two together and then push out the back of the house... Let's take a look at it. So if I use this as the main building, right? And then come out the back of it and go around on there. Because the front of the house is right there. And I could build out the back. Getting old sucks. Eva, well, it has its advantages and disadvantages. Physically, yes, yes. When things don't work like they used to and... your body doesn't behave like you expect it to, then yes, that's inconvenient as hell. God damn it. Boy, you know, these things are just in the wrong place. They're just in the wrong place. Although I gotta tell you, Eva, I wouldn't trade the knowledge and the quote-unquote wisdom. I'm not trying to be a pain. It seems you're struggling for inspiration. Go to more places. Well, I am inspired. Dude, see, the thing is, Doc, okay, this is one of the things that that gives me difficulty sometimes, is normally when I go into a place, I have just a very vague idea of what I want to do, right? So, like for 10 Pines, I wanted one settler, he had a field, and he had a chem station. That was the three basic things I wanted to do. No big deal. Easy. Not complicated in the slightest. This one here, I have. Kevin says you got to tell a story, and I do have a story sort of I want to tell. I want him to be a specific type of person. And so to that end, and plus I have 8 floors, so I have a lot more to do. Because the hardest part, see, once I start building, it's easy, right? It starts flowing. But I don't want to start in a place that doesn't have the potential to grow into something that I will be unhappy with. Does that make sense? I don't know. It's like I'm trying to pick the color palette and before I grab the brush. Because once I put the paint on the palette, I'm stuck. I've got to use it, you know? Let's just go ahead and get rid of all this shit right now, because I'm going to get rid of it anyway, I know. So that's why I'm taking... That's why this one's so difficult. Because I think, okay, let's try this. And then I sort of sketch it out in my head a little bit. And it doesn't work. Because it doesn't go the right way. And then I say, okay, well, let me think about using this as the anchor. Because this would be an ideal thing. But then you've got this shit on the floor here that just doesn't work. And I'm like, okay, well, I'd have to elevate the floor and do all this other crap. And it's like, that's more trouble than it's worth. I don't want to deal with that shit. So looking at the inside of the house, okay... The house is out. You're hired to make tea. You get on with your tea and... Like the time we're old enough to start. Yeah, yeah. See, it's like you're like, oh, now I'm smart enough and wise enough to do X, Y, and Z, but I'm unable to do it because my back sucks or whatever. Okay, that stump's got to go. I know I'm not going to use that stump. God, they're still fighting? No wonder the Brotherhood still can't take over the Commonwealth. They're shitty shots, man. Because my initial thought was to use this. I really wanted to use this as a specific type of thing, which I think I'm going to still do. I think that's how we're going to have to do this. So if I use this, if this is the front, I can build it over the water. I can ignore the whole back, ignore that house, and just build the whole thing over here. I can't scrap this mega loader, right? I'm stuck with this damn thing. Stuck with all this shit, too, in vanilla. You know, I may have to punt and use a scrap mod to do this. But then that changes the whole complexion of it and takes the challenge out of it. Thinking. Groucho, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. I don't know. Maybe Doc is right. Maybe this is not going to work for us here. I'm doing pretty good, Groucho. I got my vitamin D therapy yesterday. Got about an hour, hour and a half. It was very, very pleasant. Hadn't realized how much I missed it, and now we are back to the fray, and I'm just wandering about work water going, how can I make this thing work? And I don't think I can. I don't think it'll fit with my story. So, I had not anticipated how much of a pain in the ass this place is without scrapping mods. Because it is a pain in the ass. It is a frightful pain in the ass. Okay, change of plan. Where are we going? Somerville? Got people there, don't want that. Spectacle Island? Too remote. Boston Airport? Can't really build shit there. County Crossing Course is overbuilt to the point of pain. Finch Farm? No. The Slog's got people at it. Greentop? No. Taffington. Went to brunch, liquored up, and planned to start drinking again. Yeah, I'm curious, dog. What sound effect are you doing? What sound effect is the drinking game predicated on? Why not Hangman's? That's a very good question. One is because Hangman's is a pain in the ass. The default ground in vanilla is such a suck. It's just, ugh. I mean, it can work, but not being able to scrap that angled building is just gives me hives. Well, it doesn't give me hives, but it makes me crabby. Red Rocket. I already built a 10-pine. Zamonja. I could do Zamonja, but no. I don't have Covenant unlocked because I hate it. Starlight is no. You know, let's check Hangman's. Oh, the doink, doink when it shoots someone in the head. Oh, yeah, that's... that's what I figured. I had a suspicion that might be it. It's another small build. Well, small for most people, yeah. Eight floors for me, Eva, is huge. Because I feel friggin' tiny. Okay, so here we are at Hangman's. What have I got here? I have got nothing here. I have done nothing with this place. Absolutely nothing. Now, the ground at Hangman's is a pain in the ass, but I've learned to work with it. You know, with a little bit of fiddling and a lot of patience, it's not terrible. It's just, this building is such a piece of shit. You should be able to scrap this building, okay? This building is terrible in every sense of the friggin' word. It is just awful. Oh, I have built something here. A ladder so I could jump over the wall. So, huh, another Hangman's build, though, huh? I built so much, I don't know. You know what, though? It might be Coastal Cottage. Let me take another look at Coastal Cottage while I decide and decide and decide. Jesus. I'm all over the place today, man. All over the place. Skit says, I'm talking to this girl who likes to play Fallout, but doesn't watch my channel. Deal breaker? Oh, no. Not at all, Skit. That just means she's got taste, dude. Not a deal breaker at all, man. Not a deal breaker at all. Plus, it's good to have your own things, and she has her own things, you know? But, yeah, no, that's not a deal breaker. Sin City Boy, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How's it going? Long time no see, man. Long time no see. Okay. So Coastal Cottage again. And again, you can't scrap this stuff. I'm going to get rid of that car, though. Can't scrap these friggin' containers. It's so stupid. So stupid. The struggle is real. Well, I mean, it's like once I see a certain spot and something in my brain goes, aha, then I can do it. But see, the thing about Coastal Cottage is without mods, man, I just can't scrap all this stuff. And it's just, it's such a pain in the ass. It's so terrible. You can't scrap this broken house. You can't scrap these trees because they're not flagged. You can scrap these trees down here, though, which is dumb. I mean, it makes sense that you scrap the trees. But you got this thing here and this thing here, and then, okay, and all of a sudden you can't scrap anything else. Like, fa. And the house, as Kevin has detailed, is the biggest pain in the ass in the Commonwealth. Absolutely the biggest pain in the ass in the Commonwealth. Do I have Far Harbor unlocked? Yes, I do. I built on Dalton Farm. Well, no. I don't know. It's a good question. Do I have Far Harbor unlocked? So I don't like building at Far Harbor. Yeah, I have it unlocked, but here's the Rook family house. Have I not done it? Quartermastery Far From Home. Yeah, I haven't even unlocked Far Harbor yet. I mean, I could build at Longfellow's. Longfellow's might not be terrible, but then I'd have to play through it to do it. I do have, we're going to be in a manager? Boy, you're moving up quick, dude. You've only been working there, what, 3 months or so? Something like that? Far Harbor. Damn. Let me take another look at the Commonwealth before we go jaunting off to do playthroughs. Kingsport? Yeah, Kingsport and Croup Manor. Let's take a look at Croup Manor. You know, hitting for a frosty. Yeah, the last time, man, we were talking about it, everybody's like, I'm going to Wendy's now. Huh. Yeah, with the unofficial Fallout patch, the ghouls got cleaned up. Could this work? Yeah, but I can't scrap the trash, man. Just can't scrap the trash. That is the one mod that I find I miss more than any others, is being able to scrap all the trash. Because it is just so utterly dumb that you cannot scrap all the trash. Yeah, it's too limited over there. Too much trash in the thing over here. Too much, not enough room back in the trees. The house, of course, is a piece of shit. Oh, yeah, fighting in that house over there. Just don't blow up on me, please. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Oh no, no news, Eva. That's absolutely. I mean, that's suggestions. That's why I find I enjoy building on a live stream. So y'all can chip in and tell me stuff, and I'm like, hey, that's a good idea. That's something I wouldn't have thought of. So I always like to check it out. If I had unlocked it, I'd probably just head straight there and start looking at Longfellow's, because it definitely has potential. But you know what? Maybe Sunshine Tidings. They're stalking me. Well, I'm a sentinel. I mean, you know, well, I'm not a sentinel yet. I think I'm just a knight or a paladin at this point. But Yeah, the ghouls. Bribed your wife into going to Wendy's. Okay. So, Sunshine, I've clearly done something. Yeah, and you can't move the ghouls here. They don't go away, you fucker. And this place would be pretty much ideal for what I want to do. Could I make it? No, it's not, because it's... I mean, if I use this building... Sin City Boy says, I've only been there 4 months. You're one of the strongest people already. Well, of course you are, dude. You're a pimp, dude. Mad. Mad skills. You're going to do fine, I think. You're going to do fine. It's good to see that they're actually working with you, and it's still working out, you know. And that's cool. And I assume your schedule is settled down enough, because if you're going for a manager, you have to have the ability to have a somewhat regular schedule. But that'll be better for you, I think, right? At least in the grand scheme. Yeah, just a bunch of shit in here. Sunshine is just so perfect for the... Yeah, and I love building on this building. Love building on this building. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Go ahead and ask Doc for recommendations. He'll have to make a list on Dropbox because there'll be so much of it. Here, let me send you one of the consoles on my 5 terabyte hard drive. I'll just go ahead and we'll just stream it to you. We'll just we'll do the file sharing shit. Okay. Yeah, there ain't nothing here, man. God. Everything is so close, you know? Could this house work? Because can I scrap these things here? Doesn't the building count towards your floors? Well, I would probably count it towards my floors. If I did use a building, I would measure it and say, yeah, I'll deduct this from my thing. But here, again, you got these corpses that you can't get rid of, you know? And, anything in the chest? No, nothing in the chest. But I can get rid of the table, which is good. I can scrap that thing. Can't get rid of the glowing stupid crap back there. But if I made this... And see the bushes? It's just... Ugh! I may have to just bite the bullet and do a scrap mod, I think. What about using the silo somehow? The thing I'm trying to do does not lend itself well to that. The silos are actually inside the borders. They are actually inside the borders. Just barely, but they are. But the thing I want to make, yeah, see, but this... Wow, you got a good point. This is a good area to build in here, isn't it? And if that house is intact, instead of having the front end boarded up, I could totally use that. And build the whole thing right in here, which would... Actually, be kind of cool. But if I use a scrap mod, I could actually take this thing off, clean out the inside of this house. Ooh, you know. And on the other side of it over here, we've got... I hope you guys can see this. I hope it's bright enough. On the other side of the house, we've got these trees and this open spot right here. So you got an open spot on the left side of the house, an open spot on the right side of the house. It's kind of gathered up. Then the house itself... Pretty constant schedule. That's awesome, Sensei. That's awesome. That's awesome. What do I have going on in this playthrough at Nordhagen, True Fly Ass? You know, that's a very good question. I don't think I've unlocked it. Yeah, I haven't unlocked it because the sellers won't talk to me. Let's go out there. Yeah, that's a good point. That's a really good one to barnacle off of that I've done before, obviously. But given what I want to make out of this thing, it might be perfect for this. That's why I didn't think of it, right? Because I haven't unlocked it, True Flot. So, okay, Sunshine's got possibilities if I install a scrap mod. And these bastards will not talk to me.
Need to get back to Diamond City one of these
right?
days. Biggest town I ever saw.
If you ain't been up to see Gregor...
See? They won't give me a mission.
Whole place is
now, I have not let Preston out, but what happens is when you get to the Brotherhood, right? When the Brotherhood comes, Tegan has those missions... where you go extort the farmers, right? Apparently, when they arrive, the game picks a settlement to use as the first one and locks it out. And I think that's what's happened here. So you can't unlock this as your own settlement because it's already reserved for Tegan. But, again, I need a scrap mod for this. We're back. All right. Welcome back. Welcome back. So we're never changed the answer. Da, 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 da. Artists like Ella just don't do it for me. I gotta tell you, I'm with Doc on that one, except for At Last. When she does At Last, dude, I get goosebumps. I'm like, that's just a perfect song, dude. It's so awesome. She does such a good job in that song. I can overlook my hesitance for. Okay, enough of that babbling. Let's go ahead and see what we got here. Because if I had to murder these people, I totally will. I don't care. But I think you know what? Sunshine is better. Sunshine is better for my purposes. Eva's idea about the silos was perfect. So now what I need to do is go back to Zamonja. Move us. No, you know what? I'm just going to make a robot to hell with it. That'll be even better. Sin City asks, what am I trying to do? I'm trying to pick a location to start the build for Kevin's challenge. It's 8 floors. You can use 8 floor pieces. You can use any mod you want. You have to tell a story. And it has to have a theme to it, a very strong theme to it. And I have one in mind, but I couldn't make it work with some of the Supervisor Green. No. Give me one of the Mr. Handies. Give me you. Come here, you. Oh, wait a minute. Are you selected? Am I selecting you? Yeah, there we go. Now, you go to Sunshine. Assign supply line. Yes. Go. Now, my map looks all funky. While I'm here, let me just drop some turrets so their defense is not zero anymore. Oop, no. Get outside of the area. Put you up there on the roof, because why the hell not? It doesn't matter, I don't care. Come on, man. Why don't you go up there? Go up there. Why won't you go up there, man? What the hell? Do they have to go up here? Okay, yeah, fine. I'll put it up there to hold it. Just for the numbers anyways, right? Put 3 turrets up there. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine. What about Warwick? I don't like to build where there's people. True flot. I like to be able to control how many settlers I have. Jamaica Plain? Jamaica Plain has potential, but again, there's too much stuff there for my purposes. I want a small anchor, but Jamaica is just so limited and full. You know, I mean, it has its, and I built there so many damn times, man. You know, I built there almost as much as I have at Ten Pines. Probably the same. Let me see here. Let's get my scrap mod on. Yeah. You built yours at Somerville. Again, they have settlers there. They don't want to have to kill that dad. So. And I haven't really built much at Sunshine. I built one for the Mega Build, and I built one for Moribund. And what I'll be doing, and I built one early on that was really, you know, crappy. So, yeah, the Sin City, the links are in the description for the two challenges. Okay. So, you know what? Let's go to Sunshine, which is now linked. Let's go. Yeah, and I think Sunshine is going to be... Sar needs therapy, he hates people in his taste. I don't hate people, but when I'm building, if I have people there, the settlement can be attacked. And I hate having to deal with settlement attacks while I'm trying to get things done. Here, there are zero people, right? I will move settlers here when I need them, or I will attract more. So, booyah. And you know what? All right. Yeah, we got to do it. Sorry, folks. Save and quit the main menu. I'm going to go ahead and load my scrapping mods. So if y'all want to go ahead and make a sandwich, get a drink, do whatever, we're going to have a little intermission of a couple of minutes here while I bank up this, bank up these mods. Because I just, cannot. Too lazy to fight back. When I'm in building mode in my head, dog, I'm in building mode. You know, I'm not in combat mode, and it's hard to switch gears out of that. Plus, I forget to go to build mode when I try to start fighting, which is a problem. So there's that as well. And in Kevin's, I can actually use mods. So we're gonna turn this on. Yeah, baby, all four of those, and right. Workshop decorations pack updated, huh? Okay. Now we reload. So neurotic. It's more of a one-track mind focus thing, Doc. It's just part of the way that... Well, you've seen how easily I get distracted, right? It's like I completely go to pieces. So, yeah. All I forbid is OC decorator. But that's cool. I get you. This is my own personal limitation there, Kevin. Or sushi, whoever's talking on the... There's a word for that. Oh, I'm sure there is. And I'm sure it's not complimentary. So let's go back here. Neurotic. Nah, not neurotic. I'm focused. Focused. Focused, Doc. I'm focused. Okay. Now we go. Rifles are generally long of average size. That's average size, dude? Average size. Okay. Kevin, right now. Okay. Yeah, now, and like I said, Kevin, I don't really mind. I just didn't want to use a heavy mod load for this. I just wanted to use just enough, you know, just enough to get the job done. Okay, how are we doing? Oh, baby, that is what I'm talking about. Of course, the bad thing is I got to be careful not to scrap the silos. So, okay, so we have picked a location, and it is going to be this. It's going to be right here. Let's scope it out on my ladders and make sure that we are doing our thing. Yep. And up and up. Yep. See, just a decorating pod. Yeah, you know what? On the ladder looking at it, this is going to be perfect. Because I can build two wings off that main building, use the main building as my main building is the main building. And build down in the front here, and then off to the side there. And I can go around the back here, and there's nothing here. So let's go ahead and get to scrapping. Let's clear the decks here. Put you away. Now I gotta be really careful here, because I don't want to scrap the building, my mistake. See, there's the building. I don't want to scrap the building. I want to keep the building. Hopefully it will play nice with the rest of it. But the best part is, bye-bye. Scrap the bed, scrap this trash pile, scrap this trash pile. Scrap leaves, scrap trash. Okay, so now we've got... the ability to do things. Let's put you right there for later group selecting potential. And in here we have, see, I can't touch that tree though, because it's outside the build area. Oh, you suck. You suck. That's okay, I'll just cover it up with something. I'm gonna scrap that dresser, huh? Can't store it. Can store the patio chair. Okay. So here we go. We're laying it out. I can pick up this rock, so I will do that as well, because I can use that later. Yeah, let's get rid of the vines. Can I get rid of the... I just saw it. There it is. Yes, and vines here. Son of a bitch. Mm-hmm. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, I'm gonna count the house's floors. Don't worry. I'm not gonna try and pull a fast one here. Okay, let's do this. Let's scrap the leaves first. The vines first. Okay, so I gotta remember that it will recognize the vines. Yes. If it says SCT base static, do not scrap it. Holy shit. I didn't want to do that. Okay. Let's do that. And I'll, like I said, when I start doing it, working on it, Kevin, I will measure the house to make sure I know how many floors it is. Because for me, you've seen my builds, man. 8 floors is a ton. Is a ton. It's ton. It'll be a ton of space. I will not have to worry about it. Leaves, trash, and put that away. Scrap that. Scrap the broken chair. Scrap the trash. Dresser. Scrap trash. Can't go too fast here. Gotta be careful. Bookcase, leaves. Cool. Okay. Scrap the trash and scrap trash. And scrap trash. Okay. I'll leave that. Wait a minute, can I move this bush? No, I cannot move the bush. Okay. I can move rocks and I can move those little... I can move the rocks and I can move those little, things. I have to keep that in mind. I can move the rocks. Hell, I could probably move the silo too, right? Look at this. And look at that. Hollow. It's all a facade. Nothing is real. There is no silo. And look at that. We can move the rocks. Yeah, let's just move the rocks. Okay. Is this STS? Yes. The scrap that settlement, scrap that Commonwealth. I run both of them. I run the living and dead patch as well so I can scrap the ghouls. That is what I'm doing. 61, 39. Yeah, it's about, I think it's about 74 outside here. Yeah, Discord is a software mobile app. Yes. Definitely install the app. Just go to discord.com. And you definitely want to install it on your computer. Don't use the web version. The web version has a number of significant problems. What is this? A plank? Oh, I'll store that for later, too. Why not? Man, look at that. It's a shelf. Everybody loves shelves. Is this the one used to be able to fix the wing? Yes. Yes. Yes, it is. You know what's funny? Doc Type is asking that, too. And you know what? Let's do a little intermission, and I'm going to do that right now. Let's do that right now. Let me show you how this thing works, Doc. Because I know you asked me about this like twice or three times or a bunch of times ago, and I kept forgetting to do it. So you saw Scrap That Settlement, Scrap That Commonwealth, right? I'm running both of those with the unofficial patch. I think it might be the unofficial patch that helps me do it as well. But Starlight is on the network. So here we go. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, I forgot to scrap the barrels. Eh, whatever. Don't care. Wah, wah. But see, if you have scrapped that settlement 15 times... I did remember, but then I kept forgetting, man, you know? But if you look, as soon as you touch it, it's green. And you can just pick it up. Right? So, let's go ahead and move this. Move the topper. And I gotta scrap the car, but I don't want to scrap the car until I have moved this. So when you move it, when you pick it up, right, you can't place it anywhere unless you set it on the ground. And it's real, real fiddly about where it gets set down. But, stick it right there, right? Take the support, move the support out of the way, put it over here. And then we can scrap the car, because I know the car won't take anything with it. You move the other support, which is underneath here. And some other debris, let's get rid of that, and then get rid of the car. And some floating vines, which we will now get rid of. Okay, so now we're working with this. Now the trick to this, well, not really a trick. The biggest pain in the ass of this is this concrete stuff here, with Scrap That Commonwealth, is really weird. It does weird things underneath. Unfortunate, unpleasant things underneath. You know what? Let me get some daytime here. Oh, I hear a cow. Damn it! Yeah, we're not doing this. can you build on the wing mount? I don't. Yes and no. Give me a second. Now, your question may be answered as I go through this. And he is not scrappable. So, actually, let me get his shit off him. Let's get him out of the way here, because of course they interfere with my jam. The concrete does weird things. Yeah, crude but functional is another one too. Boom! Get out of here. Okay, that should be far enough away. And the other one's out of the way. Okay, good. All right. Got some caps. What he's doing caps? I don't know. So what I do is build a chair. Let's build a bed. What the hell? Why not? I can sleep in a sleeping bag. What, can I stick on the table? No. Okay. So this turned into something a little bit different, but that's fine. Something I've been wanting to do for a while, and now that we're here, you can rug glitch the wing mount. I group selected them. I just group selected all this stuff because it's easier for me to figure out. So what we gotta do here first is, of course, build ourselves a ladder. So let's go ahead and get our structures and get our ladder. La di di, da di da. And the wing is gonna go right there. So I'm gonna need this to be right about here. Is this high enough? Yeah. Okay. So what I need to do is move the rug. What you gotta do when you fix the wing is you move the ladder over here, so you can see the seam a lot better. And that way, when you put the thing on there. Now, I'm gonna ask for your patience here, because I have not done this since the challenge. I've had no reason to do this. Okay, so the wing is which way? Is it like this? Yeah. Okay. So the leading edge, the leading corner is right here. Come here, you. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. And down. So the leading edge is right there. Now, where did I? Okay. So what I want to do is I put the pillar on the inside of the joint where it's going to meet the building, because that's the spot that's going to be the closest and where I need to rotate it from. And then what I do is I raise it all the way up and get the pillar just underneath it so that I have the maximum amount of sinking possible. And so I can see the bottom edge of the thing, right? Because seeing this thing and lining the damn thing up is the biggest pain in the ass, because it's really hard to see the back of it. Now, the reason I did the wing first is because... Actually, I need to get this ladder closer. I do the wing first because I can put everything underneath it a lot easier with group select. But I've got to be able to see the leading edge of that seam, and I need to be higher. So let's go ahead and put another stairway there. And the tricky part is I need to see the inside edge and the outside edge at the same time while still being close enough to get the pillar to go far enough away. And... yeah, so there's a lot of moving parts here, even though there's only really one moving part. But you just grab the whole wing and then just stick it up there. Now, this takes a little fiddling to get it right. And I see I can't see where the thing is. And you go up and you go in. And see, now the pillar's not working, so now I got to raise the pillar up a little bit. Now I know... the ground there is very small, very short. Alex, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Welcome to the stream. So anyway, this is how I fix the wing, dude. It's just a very long, fiddly little process where I have to get the height of the pillar just right because it doesn't like to sink into the ground. See, as soon as it gets down there, as soon as it touches that thing, it goes weird, it goes wonky on me. So you raise it up, pull it in. And then once it goes red like this, you can see it darker. Normally I would just go ahead and go do the gray trick, you know, where I make it gray so I can see the outlining edges. But this looks straight enough, right? And then you push it over a little bit to see where it is. Raise it up a little bit, and it breaks the seam right there. So now I can see it. Pull it out a little bit, pull it in a little bit, rotate it, push it back, and... it's probably not quite close enough, but that'll do. So you get the idea anyway, right? And from here, it's just going down here, lowering this until it goes down, right? Because now I can see the flashing. Do this, pick it up again, raise it up. See, now it doesn't work because I can't see the bottom of it. So now I move it out a little bit. But yeah, it's just fiddly work. But you can see how it works, right? And it's possible. It just takes a little bit of patience. And then once you get that done, you just take the struts, and either just slide them right the hell underneath there, because they're really soft on the top, and you can just put them up pretty much wherever. And you know, go back and forth in their side, and you know, count the. Okay, you know what? I'm tired of jumping over this goddamn bench. But you count the number of tiles. It's like 1, 2, and it's on the edge of the third tile from the building. So then you go back out here, and you go 1, 2, edge of the third tile from the building. So it goes right about here. Sink it, whatever. Stick it there, la-di-da, and that's it. So that's how I fixed the left wing. And of course, this piece, same way. You just pick this thing up with the scrap mod. Group select it. And just, you know, attach it. Do the same thing with the thing. I did this in the dirt. I did this one in the dirt so I could get better thing. That's all there is to it. Scrap.com will let you pick up that wing and do that. And it's just, like I said, it's just fiddly, and you gotta look for the right hotspot, and yada, yada, yada. But there you go. There's the answer to the wing question. I'm just gonna leave it here, because why the hell not? Pretty straightforward, though, right? It's just one big-ass object with a bunch of fiddly shit in the ground, and you just do that. And then, you know, put this thing back up on top where it belongs, and eyeball it from the other side of the wing, and like that shit. Okay. So now let's go back to Sunshine Tidings and do some actual work on this thing. See if I can't get this done in an hour. I tried it so many times, I had to hide your guns. You never get it to work. It is, Doc, it is a fiddly pain in the ass. And it just, I've never been in a But every time you ask, I've never been in a game where I either hadn't built Starlight or had this mod running. And I'm like, okay, now I can do it. It's like, yes, thank you for reminding me. So all credit to Doc for putting the idea in my head. He's like, oh yeah, that's it. So what are we going to do? So this guy, this settler, is going to be a pipe weapon merchant. He is going to make them, manufacture them, and sell them, and this bush has to go. So I'm gonna have him live in this house, and I'll have him come into his shop this way. Nalena, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Scrappy building does not seem like fast building. It's the thing about scrappy building, Eva, that I like a lot about it, is it's better if it's not perfect. So it's a lot faster. You just don't have to give a shit. It's like, yay, I can just throw this crap in here. All right, Kevin, let's do some measuring here, dude. Looks like I'm going to be using 4 of my floors for this house. Looks like I'm using 4 of these floors. There's 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, it's definitely 4 floors. Okay, so we're going to use 4 floors. 4 of my floors are for the house. Okay, all right. Let's get my inventory out here so I don't forget. 1, 2. Put that over there. Uh-oh. Yeah, what the hell, that's funny. And 3, and 4. And 5. No, only 4. I'm only gonna put 4 out there because that's all I got left, right? Yeah, that's all I got left, baby. I only got 4 floors left. Because 4 are going to be for this house. Wouldn't the porch count as another floor? Oh, you're right. The porch counts for 2 more floors. Ooh, boy, maybe I won't use that house. Look at that. That is very interesting. So if I use that, So if I use this cabin, I'm burning 6 floors in this bad boy, aren't I? Huh, is this gonna be worth it? How about, you know what? let's see if I can't do this. Can I do this? Will it let me do this? I can pick up the house, right? Okay. So, can I group select it? No. It does not recognize it as a valid object, does it? No, because I can't build it. Back here, maybe? No. So I cannot group select this house. So I'm thinking if I group selected it, just buried the floors, I can maybe get around it, right? And say, well, you can't see the floors. He's living on dirt. He's just using the walls, but the concrete. But it doesn't recognize this as a valid structure. And I can't really put it anywhere else, right? Yeah, no, it's got no... Oh, what? I put it on the floor and it worked. Hmm. Okay, let's do some quick saving here. Judging by the screen capture. Well, thanks, Nalady. We're actually at Sunshine now. I'm working on Kevin's challenge now. The screen cap was for 10 pines. And if you go back and review the beginning of the stream, you can see it there. But yeah, it came up pretty good. We decorated it in the first, 45 minutes? And if I do it here? Yeah, I won't group select at all. Okay. So now the question is, do I want to use this cabin? Am I willing to sacrifice so much of my potential build for the cabin? Happened. That's okay, lady. We got you. Try to put it on a rug. The thing is, I can't set it down anywhere, Kevin, or Sushi, Kevin. It doesn't turn green anywhere. Oh, it did there, right? But I can't even begin to imagine where the hell the hotspot is on this thing, you know? But you know what? What the hell? Let's give it a shot. Let's see what's possible. This is the fun part of building, right? Can I even get this thing to do normal things? Let's raise this up just a smidge. Okay, what the hell is going on here? I can't group select anything here? Is it because of the ground? Dude, what the frick? I literally cannot select this rug. Can I group select anything here? Because if I can't group select anything here, this changes the complexion of this entire project. Oh, there it goes. Okay, so it just couldn't be in that spot. Okay, mental note. So let's pick up this stupid house and see if we can put it on this rug. We're going to rug an entire cabin, dude. That's what's happening here in the Sardeliac Sunday stream. We are rugging cabins. Okay, I hopped up there. Yeah, I'm not seeing any green here. Not seeing any green. But it is worth a shot. Yeah, see, it goes right through the rug. It doesn't even recognize it as a valid surface. Okay, that's fine. Is this Fallout 69? How you doing? Welcome to the stream. It's Fallout 4. Fallout 4. We're not doing 76 on this channel ever. So now do I really want to use this cabin? Because it is 6. Can I scrap it? Yes, I can scrap it. But the whole point of coming here was to use it. I wanted to use it. Of course, if I could just move it away from that tree, that'd be sweet, wouldn't it? Yeah, it's not going to go green anywhere here, is it? Nah. Nah. Build on a little ridge? Well, I'm going to use the silos. When you said the silos, I'm like, huh, that's a decent thing here. But, I hope that's Kevin talking on Sushi's account right now, because if not, dude, it got really weird really fast. Building the ridge. I am going to use the silos. The silos thing was a neat idea. But what I want to do is make him a little manufacturing, and I guess I could do that. Damn it, I cannot. two floors. This uses six, man. This uses six. And if it uses six... I like the spot, though. I like the spot. So, goodbye, house. Goodbye, cabin. And hello, floors. Let's get our floors back now. So now our anchor is going to be the silos. That's what's going to happen here. God, this is... Man. When they call him a challenge, he's not kidding. This is a challenge. It is very much a challenge. And there's five, six, and seven, and eight. Okay. All right, I got eight floors. I got a big empty spot right here. Big empty spot. You built a small player home from those silos this morning? Well, look at that. Great minds think alike. Am I right? Am I right? The tree can't be scrapped because part of it's outside the build. Well, the thing is, the hotspot that it recognizes is outside the build border, so it doesn't even see this as an object. It just sees it as a collision plane, I think. Simple rules, harder execution. That is absolutely fair. There's a piece of wood. Oh, no, it's in front. That's fine. My modern art piece here is a study in simplicity and defying the laws of physics. I wonder, can I group select any of this shit? Maybe, maybe not, right? Oh, hey, hey, hey! That'll work. So, let's see. What am I going to do with the Groucho? This is going to be interesting to see how much, how similar they are. Okay. So now, of course, what am I going to do? Get my ladders out again to see, to look at what I'm working with here. What am I working with? What kind of mess do we have going here? Because if he's back here... Yeah, that is a really nice little spot, isn't it? Modern art gallery! Wasteland Sculptor's Cabin. Yeah, I could just start gathering up all the rocks here, right? And then putting, like, raider corpses on them or some shit. Be all, like, Pikmin in stone. The new exhibit. Okay, well, first order of business is definitely going to be to fence off the back corner. Because... That raider house back there is going to be a problem if they come at it from this angle. And I want to tuck it underneath here. Just want to do that. Let's see. What do I want? I want wood walls. Huh. Haven't used this one much. How much does it sink into there? A little bit? Not at all. Okay. How sensitive on a... Okay. And a crim on the, next to a mini nuke, right? A mini nuke and a couple of stim packs. The duality of man. Well, let's grab this one. Right? Yeah. Okay, let's start building some shit. Let's start making some stuff. Eight full floors, that's going to be big. It may be big, but what I think I'm going to do, true flat, is I'm going to make it condensed by building up a little bit more than I usually do. I'm going to try that and see how it works. This is going to be a lot of experimentation here. And I can't see. It's getting dark, so I'm going to have to sleep again. What's really inside the can? The duality, it's a mystery. It's mystery meat. Mystery meat. Am I far enough away? Yeah, not enough. Not enough. Okay. Let's do this. All right, and up. And come on, I just saw it. Okay, I forgot that the ladders are a little bounding box excitable, so let's do that. How far does it go? Not far enough, of course. Man, I am not having a good day. okay here, folks. I apologize. This is not going as planned. Can I even grab this thing? Okay. All right, up we go. Up we go. Okay, this should... Yeah, there we go. Okay. So then it goes to here. Shove it in there. Is that the right angle? Yeah, it looks good, right? Oh, come on, you just did it. And then up. Just the full. So we want to go to about there. Is it in there? It's close. It's not perfect. But it suffices. And we're going to raise it up a little bit more. Up a bit more. Yeah. Okay. Let's start filling this bad boy in and see if I can get an anchor going and see if I can see what the hell it is I'm even wanting to do here. Structures, walls, fences, junk fence, junk fence, junk fence. Which one looks more structurally sound? It's got to be this one, right? It's got to be this one. Got to be this one. Okay. So let's see what we got here. Oh, the wind died down. Strange. And up. Okay, so it needs to be just a little bit lower. No, not you. I want this one. So it needs to be just a little bit lower. No, I'm just going to select the silos, right? It's going to grab everything with my luck. No, it did not. Excellent. So we put it down to about there. Right. Now the thing about using floors to TrueFlot is that if I just build stairways, every platform is a quarter of a floor, so I can just eat up the budget doing that as well. We will see how this goes. We will see how this goes. But for now, for the nonce, we're going to put that here. Come on. Right? Yeah, just a little bit inside there. So the corrugated tin shows through. We push it down so it looks like it's resting on the tires. And now we pray that my trick works and this does not drop. And it did not. And it looks dumb. Because it's got to be centered on the tires. Yeah, no, that's not going to work. Okay. Building without junk fences. That would be cruel. I wouldn't do it. I couldn't do it. I'd be like, yeah, nope, you win. Your challenge has defeated me. I can't do that. So do this, and we'll put a... Thank our patrons one more time. Thank you very much for your additional support, folks. I very do much appreciate it. And we're going to be seeing more things on the channel, hopefully soon, once I get a new friggin' controller. All right, so we're saved. Let's go out here. We're saved! We're saved! Oh, good, I can see better now. Even better. All right, floor coverings. Get my super rug. Yeah, this is not gonna work because it's gotta go. Actually, let me see what it looks like on the top here. Put it on the rug. Come on, baby, be good. There we go. And now what I want to do is look at the top of this thing, because I've never actually done this kind of maneuver before. So let's see what we've got here. So the top of the wall. Okay. So it's got a little, it's like a V almost. So if I line it up on that strut and between that post, it should be perfect. Right? So I want to get it between the two posts, which looks like this. Then I line it up on the strut, push it through a little bit, which looks like that. So I can't have it to have the look I want, but how's that? Okay. Okay, that is acceptable. That is workable. That is consistent. No time limit on this challenge. No, not on either one of them. Neither one of them have a time limit, true flaw. So you can do them whenever. But when you do Kevin's, you got to do a short video. 5 minutes. Curtis Mayfield. Yes, Curtis Mayfield. Absolutely 100%. I agree with you completely. Okay, now the problem is I did not figure on that thing, and I know these... Oof, I know this wall doesn't like to play nice with those, but we're going to find out if it does or not. So I'm going to wall this off a smidge. And we're going to see if we can't get this to work. Because I forgot that this wall is really twitchy around the junk fences. I heard something. What did I hear? A bear? Was that my stomach? Who knows? Okay, so how close can I get this thing to the... Oh, look at that! Well, higher? Yeah, it's got to go higher, huh? Because the junk wall doesn't let me touch any lower than that. It doesn't let me touch any lower than that. That's what she said. Okay, what have we got? So that's lined up there. Good. And then we'll put the other one here for variety. And, mic was off when I let one loose. So it's the Drinkin' Doinkin' Fartin' channel. Six Pack Cartoon Network and Bring Extra Beans. I thought you said it went to Wendy's, not Taco Bell, dude. What's up with that? What's up with that, man? Put it down a little bit. Angle it in a little bit. Okay, it won't angle in, so that's fine. Yeah, that's good. That's good. And then, okay, so it's curving in a smidge. It's gonna be the bear and the maiden fairy. Indeed. Barn walls. Where's my scrappy barn walls segment thing down here? Yeah. Let's add this to the mix. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Stick that like that. Is that? No. Gotta do it the other way. Gotta do it the other way. So it makes sense. As much as it sense. Dance like a spur. Doc, you living on the edge, man. I'm telling you. I'm telling you, man. Crazy. Crazy. Okay, nope. Well, look at that. The outside edge is softer than the inside edge. Isn't that interesting? Isn't that interesting? Up you go. How's that? Yeah, that'll do. That'll do. That's a little bit better. Now you can stick another junk wall in there. Where's my no, not display. Floor coverings. You go here. Raise her up a little bit. Yeah, my link is to the French one. That's where he did the... I didn't see that he had the English one. Because I saw the 4K subscriber thing. I was all excited. I'm like, 4,000 subscribers, dude, sweet! And then I didn't even think to look on the English channel for it because I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer, apparently. This one? Yeah. Yeah, we'll do this one. Wait a minute. That one went outside, so we have to put this one inside. Yeah, that's how I have to do. I have to do this one here. The wind is weird here at Sunshine. It keeps dying. It's very strange. Oh, there it is again. It's like when I move into Sunshine, the wind starts, but when I move outside towards the build area border, it stops. Yeah, so no wind here. And wind here. No wind here. But wind here. Aha! You know what it is? The wind doesn't blow when you're inside the cabin. But there's no cabin here anymore. So the actual sound effect thing is still working. How cool is that? It's the cabin. That's actually kind of neat. That they actually had that kind of level of detail that they would put that there. And, so now we know from a game coding perspective that the sound effects are linked to the actual exterior and not to the actual object. Which, of course, if they're going to, you know, do scrapping mods, makes sense. No, you know, unless you can't scrap it, they don't expect you to scrap it. Actually makes a certain amount of sense. So I need to get this to go in here and cover up all those walls and then go all the way up down to here. How do we got on the outside here? How does that look? Oh, yeah. There you go. Add a little bit of depth to it. That's how we do. That's how we do. Raise it up and grab the rug. And then set it back into place. So what we got working right now then... Well, let's store the stairs. So we have an outside wall that's sort of coming down. Let's patch that gap somehow, I think. Don't watch my Let's Plays, they're shit. They're fine, everything's fine. Duh, I'm already subbed. You can still hear the metal roofing after you scrap the house. What, when the rain hits it? That's kind of cool. Like a little window for turrets. Huh, okay. All right, folks, I got to take a real quick bio here, so I'll be back in about 30 seconds. Be right back. Okie dokie. Great story. I'm not very much of a storyteller, Doc. I'm not creative. My creativity does not run in that direction. So, you know, this guy, like I said, this guy here is going to be boring as hell. It's not going to be interesting at all. But, okay. Because, like, the build tells the story. You know, I don't think in terms of doing the... let's see here. You know. Let's put this there. Let's do my normal. I want a turret hole here to protect this side of the. Colonel Mustard, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, man. How you doing today? How's it going? Okay. So now you want this here. And it. Oh, look at that. It plays pretty nice with that piece. Gonna turn it out this way. Make it a little bit ragged. Come on. There you are. And then up you go. And then we go down to there. Yeah? Yeah. Right. Okay. Reasonable. We have that. Yeah, we're right up against the billboard already, aren't we? Jeez, man, I never learned. Yeah, another junk fence here. Even a D&D player. Yeah, well, I've role-played for a while as well, and sometimes if I get into character, yes, absolutely, I'm with you on that one. It doesn't happen as often for me as it does for most other people, I would imagine. But it, this one? Yeah, this one. But as I'm getting more and more analytical as I age and less, you know, creative. So it's like, well, I'm a problem solver, not really a storyteller as those things go. If a story gets told, fantastic, but it's not something that I have great success with. Dun, 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 dun. You thought my local four-pack story was pretty awesome? That one... So here's the little secret of that story. I literally bolted that on to the end of it once I saw what was going on. The narration, when I was narrating it, you know, I was kind of winging it, you know, kind of going as I went, winging it as I went. And then all of a sudden, around, I don't know, what was it, episode 6 or 7, it just kind of clicked. And I'm like, wait a minute, what if... Blah, and then... Bada bing, bada bang, and there it was. So, yeah, no, I didn't go into it with that story in mind. That story sort of happened to it, which was interesting. Okay. Longtime D&D player. Hell yeah, baby! Getting into characters is one of the hardest things in games like D&D. Well, yes and no. If you have good players and you don't feel uncomfortable doing it, it's super simple. Because you can just, you know, let your freak flag fly, you know. But if you get a bunch of people who are like borderline rules lawyers and, you know, nerds and shit. I mean, not nerds, bad nerds, but people that are not, they're gaming it, they're not playing it, you know. So if you get that type of thing, then yeah, it can get really, it gets really awkward and strange and uncomfortable. So yeah. You were assembling aliases, assembling analytical mind. Yeah. I'm good at having, showing up the thing. It's like, oh, here's the thing. Here's the build, you know, do the things. Not creative, makes it a cool, neat story. Yeah. Justin, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, man. How you doing, man? The players will fuck up your plans. Yeah. Improv. Yeah. Dungeon Master. If you don't know how to improv, you got no business being a DM, man. Because you're what is it? Every plan is fantastic until the enemy shows up, or what is it? No plan survives first contact with the enemy. Not that your players are your enemies, right? But it's the same thing. You got to be able to. The more you can create a world rather than a game, the easier that will be, because you know your world will have its own structure and internal consistency. And you can just say, okay, well, my world does X, Y, and Z. It has its own rules. So when they do this, my world responds this way. or the world responds this way. And that can make your life a whole lot easier. Rather than going, damn it, why didn't they pick up the 64 clues I left at the bar for them? Yeah, well, they don't do that. That's not how it works. They do their own thing all the time. But that's what makes it fun, right? That's the fun part of it, is you never know how it's going to go. And sometimes the most fun I've had is when people went completely off the reservation from the start. The DM just went, okay, you want to do that? Let's do it. And even the DM was like, man, that was fun. Just like, yeah, that's when you know you got a good game. Three-hour-long combat. Yeah, it's like, you know, sometimes you just have more fun doing the stuff that comes natural rather than the plan. Man, that conduit sinks so good to that wall, doesn't it? Look at that. Look how pretty that is. Let me drag it forward just a little bit to get the bar out, and then push it down to cover the wire. And... oh, it's perfect. Oh, I love when a plan comes together. And then on the bottom, we'll put what? What do I want to fence the bottom off with? Fergie's got an exciting group, it sounds like. I think I want to go play with you guys, man. That's like, what the hell? How'd that even happen? How does that even happen? Okay, where's the raggedy ones? Yeah, here we go. I want the raggedy ones. This one? Nah, not that one. Yeah, this one. This one, this one, this one. Now, will it let me even do this? That's the question. Okay, will you behave? Behave. Oh, behave. Oh, look at that. I can kind of sink it to the wall. Very good. Going to lower it a little bit. Oh, I saw that. Come on. I want that other board to be barely touching. And then sink that down so there's nothing in the ground. And... is that going to be... well, I guess it's as good time as any to build a turret, right? And we're going to put it on a low table. So give me a table. Give me a table. Table, table, table. Where is that low? Yeah, you know what? Let's put it on that table. Let's put the turret on that table. And turrets. And you were a mark. Look at this shit. Mark one. New. No, 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 no. Mark one, dude. That is some bullshit right there. Can I still go over here? Is it over here that it goes? It does. They fixed that though, right? They fixed that. So it doesn't do it anymore. Yeah, it's still Mark 1. Ah, I'm stuck on Mark 1 turrets, man. So yeah, it only has to be elevated a little bit to stick out. So, but the turret will not go on the table by itself. So, what do we have to do with our shitty-ass Mark 1 turret? Turret fail. Come on. There we go. So I know this is forward. So let's put it on the... let's put it on the table here. Line it up in the center as best I can from this angle. And push it up through there. So it looks like it's kind of bolted down. Yeah. Is that good? Oh, look at that! It's actually looking... that's actually kind of centered. Nice. Okay, you. Now, let's put you out here through the little sally port or what have ya, and make sure that the elevation is correct. Okay, so when the thing comes up... okay, I need to center this damn thing. I can't see. So, let's see. That's centered. That's straight. So when the turret, the barrel comes up, it's going to have to be at this height, right? Push it a little bit further back so when it rotates, the barrel doesn't actually hit the fence. That's one of those little nagging things that I see sometimes in my own builds. I'm like, ah, no, man, the turret thing touches it. Does it touch? No, it does not touch, right? How close did I get? Does it touch? No. Good. Perfect. So now my turret is there. Turret is there. Okay. Turret is there. Looking out through its little hole. Grenade shield's good. And then this is going to be... Okay, I need to put another fence over there in that area. Gotta do that. Oh, my size bar. Oh my god, the size bar. I forgot to... That's alright. Whatever. I'll fix it later. And then we're going to use another one of those. Another one of these. And up and drop. There it is. I'm going to push this thing through the... Da-da-da. I don't seem to like the laser turrets. I don't like the laser turrets because I kind of prefer, they don't really work with scrappy builds to my mind, Colonel Mustard. I mean, these people here, they're all nuts and bolts and screws and you know, oil and gas and mechanical 1890s kind of shit, you know? If I were building a vault or something, I'd definitely use them, but they don't seem to suit this sort of thing, if that makes any sense. I don't know, it just fits better, you know what I mean? The wiring I don't care about, because I'll use missile turrets all day long. But, missile turrets, again, are more sort of pseudo-mechanical, I guess? I don't know. So there's that. And if that comes out to here, then he's going to need... Okay, I need to stop fencing this off, because it's going to get too small. I'm going to run out of room to do shit. So, in our last... We haven't built shit here, have we? In the last 15 minutes, I need to build this out. We need to build out. Where's my thing? Because what I wanted to have is a shop, a storefront, that, well, based on the facing here, let's see, the dirt path kind of comes this way, right? So if you do the entrance up to this, and if I put him facing this way, let's just throw up a shack and see what it looks like. Well, not throw up a shack. Let's quickly create a shack so I can see what my facing is going to look like here. Because if I do one here and one here, no. Gotta be turned a little bit. So if I put a shop here... How's it look from this side? That's not bad. That's not terrible. Gonna need to take this wall out, though. Okay. So if I do that and then turn it this way, push it up towards the back here, that gives me the tree for decoration, right? And I could do a wall over to this way. Yeah, that could work. Hmm. Let's move this out a little bit here. And do, no, we're gonna do metal, aren't we? Yeah, let's do a metal wall here. See, I wish the metal walls didn't have that center support on the squarish ones like this. But actually, that could work for this purpose, for this application, it could work. Right? Let's do a wood floor here. I wish I had metal railings too. Not just the concrete ones, but actual metal, like tin, corrugated metal. That'd be kind of cool. But we do not. We only have the wood ones, unfortunately. So we make do with what we have. Joy. And do prefab walls count as floors? Yes, this counts as a half a floor. This would be two quarter floors right here. So right now I've got two and a half floors in use. If it has a floor, it counts as floors. Yeah, so that's a half a floor. That's a half a large floor right there, which is ABOBKB. Yeah. That no longer makes sense. Okay, so wood walls. I know I'm definitely going to be using one of these at some point, so let's stick that up there and then put this one here. Okay. Doing here? What is this going to do here? I wonder, will this work? Okay, it won't snap with that thing there, and that's fine. Uh-oh. Did I just ruin the ability to snap this? No, I didn't. Okay. That's good. Okay. And then we do... Where's my railings? Right. Okay. There's that. Then I could snap... Will it let me snap on these to the side of this? It will. Okay. Then I'm going to need another wall over here. Well, I've already got that wall built, so let me just use that as a spacer for the time being. Because what I want to do is put a roof on this thing. But I want to see if it'll even work. I'm not sure if it will or not. But what we want to do is take one of these chunky roofs, and it won't snap. Is it this thing in the way? Yes. So now, will this snap to the front? No! It will not snap to the front. Wah, wah. So close, but yet so far. So that roof is not going to work. Which roof will snap? This is the exciting part of our program. Which roof will snap? Will any of them snap? Tune in and see if any of the roofs will snap with that stupid piece in the way. And they won't, will they? They will not. Let's try this one. Because actually, this is kind of funny. And it won't snap. Scaffolding ramps are counted as stairs. Only the platforms. The ramps. Oh, the ramps? You mean the hardwood ramps? I would count them as stairs. Because they're not flat. But that is not my call. I basically just try not to abuse it, you know, and trying to work around it. Because I don't really mind. But then again, I'm, you know, scrappy, so I don't mind using dirt. I'm like, whatever, I don't give a shit. Man, I wanted this thing to fit on that so bad. And it will not do it. Well, can I pillar glitch this sumbitch in there? Because maybe I can do that. Maybe it'll behave if I try that, eh? Eh? Let's see. Get my pillar. I didn't even see that before I grabbed the pillar. So yeah, I am with you, Eva. I am with you and I agree. We are the chorus and we agree. We agree, we agree, we agree. And no one's going to get that reference. No one is going to get that reference. Okay. Sorry, I'm not talking because I am very gently moving the stick. Oh, it's not straight. Damn it. Okay, so we're going to try it this way so I can see it. Let's zoom in with a ladder. A ladder would work too. I always forget about that, you know? I never think about it, but if this doesn't work, I will definitely grab a ladder. Okay, so now comes the dock type part of our program where he's like, how do you line things up? Well, this is how I line things up. Look for the seam. Make sure they both go through at the same time. Which they do. And we go up, and then we look at the seam as it goes through the bottom of the floor there. And that's lined up. So now we just push it out a little bit. Push it down a little bit. And push it forward a little bit, maybe? Is that what I gotta do? Where's it gonna turn? Oh, there it is. So it turns green there, but not here. Okay. We go up and up. Get it just below the floorboard level, and voila. And now it is straight. And that looks actually kind of cool, man. All the extra under supports and shit. That's not bad at all. That's not bad at all. All right. No one used ladders. That's what she said. Yeah, I can't take you anywhere, man. It's okay, though. It's okay. I get you. All right. So, unfortunately, because of our fiddling, our faffing about, as they say, I was unable to do as much with this as I would have liked. But we are off to the races. We're off to a good start here. This is looking somewhat promising. Let's go for 12 hours. Looks awesome, actually. Well, thanks, Eva. It's going to be... I'm going to steal a trick from Nacho to dress the front of it up. Because right now, the front of it's really flat and bland and bare and ugly. Well, it's, you know, a warehouse piece or whatever. But he did a thing in for the challenge. And I'm unashamedly going to steal it. I loved it so much when I saw it. I'm like, yes! And that will dress up the front of that thing really, really nicely. So if you want to try and guess what it is, go check out Nacho's channel. Go look at his tour and see if you can guess what we're doing here. So, what we've got so far, which is not a hell of a lot, is we've got a big-ass wall here. Not bad. Looks pretty good. Nice and ragged. Burying stuff. We got our turret sticking out, as we do. We have a building that's going to be a storefront. It's going to be part of his house. And I don't know what I'm going to do with the inside of it or how it's going to grow. I'm probably going to make a couple of sections, and I may make it go up. Because this roof right here is just temporary. That's just a filler piece. We're going to figure that out later. But for now, let's look at what we've got. Let's see how it's going to grow from the top. Our glamour shot is not going to be very pretty for the next thumbnail. Because it's really not much here. But me no buts. But I don't want roofs. I want floors, dude. I want floors, he said, as he went to walls. No. Okay. Snap and snap. So that's... Yeah, that's not a hell of a lot, is it? So anywho, let me jump down here and get rid of that thing. All right. So yeah, that's where we are. That's what we got right there. Actually, I should probably do it here, huh? Because the light's hitting it right. That demo of the wing. Doc, come on, man. Don't be like that. I forgot, dude. I'm old. It's just an app. I'm like, I kept meaning to do it, and then something would come up, and I kept meaning to do it, and something would come up, and I'm like, son of a... So anyway, we're going to call the stream here at 2:57. I want to thank y'all very much for stopping by. Let me go ahead and put that up again. Thank the patrons for their support. I want to thank you all very, very much for your contributions and your additional, well, support of the channel here. And other things are coming soon. So turn that off and turn this on. If you like what you see, I'd appreciate hitting that like button. Let me know that this is something that you would want to see more of. I'm not sure why, but hey, it's entertaining. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see here, if you hit subscribe, there will be more. I stream Fallout on Sundays at noon central, and I stream random crap, currently Skyrim, on Tuesdays at 7. Did I say 7 twice? It's noon on Sundays. So anyways, I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, everyone.